podcasts, Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube. Whiskey influencers from every corner of the internet converge in this digital arena each February to settle a score. You think you're the best whiskey taster on the internet? You think you can carry the belt in 2023? You think you have what it takes to be crowned Matt Madness Whiskey Tasting Invitational World Champion? Prove it.
What's up, baby?
Clink them and drink them.
And drink them, baby. That's it.
I'm Josh, and I drive a Maybach.
What the fuck is that?
I have no idea.
Go balls deep.
I did not have sexual relations with that woman.
Blah, 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 blah.
I want you to be a normal human being.
I'm the only champion!
Completely unwatchable.
Let's do something crazy.
Murder. That's what I want.
Three of them are shitting their pants still, right. And then one of them is well seasoned.
We're professional whiskey tasters.
Well, who'd have seen this coming? Me sitting in the winner's seat again. I would have.
Yo, Mr. White. I've been calling you for like, I don't know, forever. Call me back, you bitch.
Okay.
Choke me, daddy.
And we know everything there is. Whiskey.
This is my Nulu apple brandy finished Nulu friggin' apple.
Why would you pick that? Why? Why would you pick that?
Wow. If he's here, who's running hell?
Definitely enjoy that quite a bit. Succulent.
Yes, thank you. Thank you all. Thank you so much.
I don't feel.
Last year, I pulled the daggum wishbone out, and I got a wish, and my wish was that your ass is still kid stable this year. Get out of my seat!
Oh, he says that I'm a big fat idiot.
I have more friends. It's great.
Daniel freaking Chuck!
Yeah, Tipsy Cam.
I'm gonna smash his fucking Glenn.
Wait, you got no cheers?
What? I asked for the distillery on the nose. Dan answered MGP. Will answered MGP. Dara answered Indiana.
Another fucking super chat.
Two-handed spankings.
Dutch! Not a chance!
They're giving this the Porter special.
It's MPG juice sourced from Indiana.
You dumb idiot!
Smoke Alec Bradley cigars or burn in hell.
I don't know how it works. I didn't even watch.
Okay, perfect.
Oh yeah. I'm ready to compete, okay? Let's go.
Oh my god!
Is that against the rules?
I cannot believe it. I like cried really hard. Yeah.
It is my pleasure to welcome one and all to a brand new season of Matt Madness. Tonight, we have Sean from the Bourbon Junkies, Josh from Stuffin' Whiskey, and Perry from This Is My Bourbon Podcast.
Oh, we've been waiting so long, living without a whiskey attorney. And there's a few new songs waiting to make fun of all you see.
Oh! I say you might in the back who delivered a pack to contestants, each one! And Shayla on screen who scores the whole thing, well she thinks she's the mathematical one! Oh! Well the stakes are heightening! Bring back Grizz Lightning! No matter how you face it! Oh, David is basic! Yeah, 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 yeah. And
And the mat in the back sent everyone a pack, and it turned into a mat madness. And the girl off screen who scores the whole thing said it turned into a mat madness. Mat madness. Mat madness. Mat madness. Mat madness.
Now raise a glass and put your hands together for the sultan of the swirl job, the master of ceremonies for Mat Madness, Mr. Matthew Porter.
What the hell is going on? God, I'm so excited. Wow.
I love that. That's my favorite song of all time. I listened to it 300 times today. And I can't help it. It's so good. That's the best song I've ever heard in my life. And I told David, I said, The Ballroom Blitz is my favorite song. And you made it better. How did you do that? Man, Mat Madness 2023 Whiskey Tasting Invitational kicking off right. Now I'm tired. Now I'm exhausted. How's everybody doing? I am so excited because tonight is the first round of the main event of the Mat Madness Whiskey Tasting Tournament. You know what I mean? The thing that we're doing. This year, the rules are going to be basically the same, but a little bit different because the title of this year's Mat Madness is hardcore. There's going to be hardcore questions and hardcore answers and hardcore love. Speaking of somebody I love, let me bring in our first contestant of the evening from the This Is My Bourbon podcast. Everybody, Perry Ritter. Perry, how the heck are you?
What's going on, y'all? It's Mat Madness 2023. I'm so freaking excited for this. That song got me so amped up. I am so freaking hyped now, dude.
I just want to just pump it in my ear the entire time. That's all I want.
I'm okay with that. Man, Matt, thank you so much for having me back again this year. Hello, everybody in the chat. I am so, so happy to be competing again. And I don't know how this happened, but it was very nice of you to put me in the round with the sidekicks for other channels. So, I mean.
Speaking of sidekicks, geez Louise, let me bring in Sean from the Bourbon Junkies, everybody. Sean, nice segue, by the way. I like that. Sean, how's it going, dude?
I'm just excited to be here. You know, every year, I think Dave and Kira cannot top themselves with their songs, and every year they just pull through. That was the best song ever.
Dude, I mean, if you know the song Ballroom Blitz, like it, you can't not listen to it and be like excited about it. And then when the just, wow.
I got my good luck cat here. She ready to go?
Oh, geez. You know what? I almost busted out a P-word joke 2 minutes into the stream. But guess what? We're not quite there yet.
I got to say, the best comment so far is nice shirt. You steal it from the Riddler?
Uh-huh. I sure did. Speaking of P-words, Josh, everybody, how's it going? Josh?
What's up, Matt? What's up, everybody?
And by P-words, I mean pro. A pro.
We are professional whiskey tasters.
That's the word on the street. That is the word on the street. Man, I am pumped. Everybody in chat, we have 554 people in here. Thank you, everyone, so much for joining us this Friday evening. I'm pumped. I am so, geez Louise. We have super chats already. Bourbon Kingdom, Taylor Super Chat. Bro, the only thing better than that song is that shirt. And this thing is, I went to go plug in something in, you know, in the wall for my wife, and it just went. And I was like, whoa, not exactly stretchy material, not exactly breathable either. It's pretty, she's pretty like airtight, you could say, you know what I mean? But I look like $14 and that's all that matters.
Not a lot of room for activities, I'm imagining.
Tony Baggett, freaking donuts. Sorry, Sean and Josh, but I'm ride or die Perry Timbip. Unless Sean wins, then I was routing for you the whole time. Cheers, boys. Tony Baggett donuts. Routing.
Thanks, Tony.
You know what he meant.
I know. Back talk already. Garrett Willett. He's such a great show. Thank you so much for putting us on. Thank you, Garrett. And then Mark Vasco. So excited for this year's Mat Madness. Thanks for bringing us all together for this, Matt, and creating such a fun event. Of course, listen, this is the best time of year for me. You know, I just love this. This is so much fun.
It's the most wonderful time of the year, some would say.
Yeah, especially if you're a winner. If you come out on top of the winner, then
amazing. Speaking of amazing, our scorekeeper this evening, Shayla Bot. How's it going, Shayla? Sorry, I just Shayla. I always Shayla. Manage to pull you in stream when you're mid-sip or something.
Oh my goodness, I am so freaking excited. I'm ready. I am so excited for the songs, but I am also very, very, very excited for the clips. So
Oh, I don't have any of those.
Okay.
Sorry.
Okay. Sorry, I forget.
Andy Allen, such great week one matchup, and also here for the great distraction songs. But event there is. Also hashtag Fire Sean. I like this Andy Allen guy. I'm not sure why, but he just kind of rubs me the right way. If you know what I mean. Yeah. Man, oh man. So thank you guys for doing this. This is the first round. Someone's got to be first, right? And if you're not first,
you're last.
Yep.
That's another thing that they say. So were you upset that I put you first, or were you like, you know, cause like Shook is all big, you know, he's like all big headed cause he's like, oh, I'm in the semifinals, but he doesn't realize how to look at a bracket. And like, those are the quarterfinals, Dan. And he's like, semifinals are the greatest. I love semifinals.
Is Cam on the other side of the bracket than Dan?
Cameron?
Yeah.
No, he's south.
Of Dan? Oh, south so Dan's Dan. Going to lose in the quarterfinals then. Okay, that's fine.
Well, this is at least my second year in a row that I've gone in the first week. So I'm hoping to redeem myself for past tragedies, but we'll see.
You know,
there's some nostalgia.
That's right. Man, oh man, I'm very sorry. This chat thing, I'm a little bit behind on everything in life, and I have no idea where I'm even at here.
Do you want to like open samples while you're reading chat?
Oh, you know what, Sean? Go ahead and get on that. Everyone, open your samples. Open them up. Pour them A through D. Don't get them confused. Yeah. But thank you for keeping me on track.
For Sean,
love you, bud.
Appreciate it, Sean, for keeping me going here. Oh no. Every time I do something, it does something different, which is a bummer. Your Huckleberry for the Focus Fund. So happy for Matt Mattis to begin. Yes, I got a new camera. I'm sure none of you can tell, but
it looks killer.
Focus is now.
Oh my goodness.
What's up?
What's the camera? What's the camera?
It's a Sony A7C. It's like a A7III in a smaller body. With a flippy screen, so I can look at my green shirt.
Whatever you use, right?
I don't know.
Oh, I asked them, and they said that's what they use. I thought they said A7 and C. I don't know.
There's a lot of A7s.
There's a lot of those.
Oh, okay. I know nothing about cameras, so.
I think that there might, you know, the shirt on my this might actually listen. You might get a shirtless pic tomorrow, everybody out there. If this thing is doing to my body what it feels like it's doing, there might be a reaction occurring, and it's going to be a rash one,
You should have expected that when you put a paisley shirt on. You know what I'll do to you.
Eric Gunderson, let's take it home. Josh, there's a bottle of Pendern Madeira cask for Aaron riding on this. What's Pendern?
It's a Welsh whiskey, I think, right?
Mm-hmm. It is.
It's a Welsh single malt that is delicious.
Ooh. Kim S. Go, Josh. Or it's multiple Kims in the same room. I'm not sure if that's Kim S. or Kim's. But either way.
It's the Kim's channel.
The Kim's. Thomas Hansel, Team Josh, 2023 is your year. Get after it. We'll see how Josh does with all these rye whiskeys I sent him this year. We'll see how he does.
You dirty dog.
Again?
Well, yeah, I mean, they're, you know, Lucas, your new camera is dope. Happy Matt Madness. Happy Matt Madness. Exactly. I'm pumped. I'm pumped. I'm pumped about everything. You had a good day today. I found some good friggin' Perry clips that just made me happy. And, you know, couldn't find anything worthy of Sean.
But, I get that.
But in not finding anything with Sean, I found some keepers for Dan.
Yeah.
Nice. Listen, this is a true story. I thought Sean interrupted Dan a lot. No, Sean just tries to put the brakes on Dan. Sean can't get a clean sentence out. Sean starts a banger of a sentence, and he's like, this is going somewhere good. And I'm like, we're recording this. And then Dan's like, blah, 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 and they're in the middle of it and wrecks it every time. Like, geez Louise. It's like, Dan can't do anything. Your partner can't do anything right. Mm-hmm.
is quite possibly one of my favorite clips that yeah. I never thought we were going to put on the channel. Dan's like, I don't know if we can use that. I was like, nah, I think we should.
Like, so the funny thing is, if I did that, I would be like, so I would be so angry and you could see it. I'd be so mad.
Oh yeah.
He, like, when that thing, when it's like he knew before it happened. He's like, oh yeah, it fell just like I thought it was gonna fall.
You had to right the slow motion, just no.
Yeah. Didn't even flinch. He just like, yeah.
Accepted it.
I love it. I love it so much. Marshall, the most wonderful time of the year. Shout out to my mother-in-law, Wendy. She loves her some Matt. Well, what's up, Wendy? I love me some of your burgers. And a couple baconator me, baby. That was so last year, Matt. I was looking at clips of last year, and I looked like I was full. You know, I don't.
Looking good this year, though.
I get that.
Back to next year, who knows what it will be. But for this year, anyway, good stuff.
Jacked and tan next year.
Last year, lots of snacks. This year, looking like a snack.
Oh, there you go.
That's what's up.
Yes, Josh.
As Sean snacks.
I'm one of only two snacks left in this house. And I have to enjoy myself, if you know what I mean. Matt Usher makes you look like an extra from Saturday Night Fever. Staying alive. Yeah. You know, I was going for just a, you know, the sweater vest. Listen, I'm all about a good sweater vest, but I felt like it was more of like I was trying to put just something on my body that was like, you know, this is new Matt. I'll dusty damn these buttons and you'll be looking at my, you know, my belly button in no time.
Do you have a really high belly button or?
No, it's really deep. That's the difference. It's really deep. Yeah. like a cavern. A soccer team got lost in it. Elon Musk tried to get him out. Saucy Shane, cheers to everyone heading home from work. Let's go, Josh.
So did the kids live, or where are we at with
that? It's an ongoing thing. We haven't actually made contact yet.
I haven't heard about that one.
Bernhard, it's for our watch party here in Justin, Texas. All five of us are cheering for Sean. We know you won't drop this like Dan in those bottles.
Sounds like I got five people rooting for me then.
That's not a bad number. That's not a bad number. He's Troy and Lisa Tool, Team Josh. Brilliant, Josh. Then Keith Casey Weld. For all the work you put into this, pocket $30 and buy an iron with $20 to smooth the creases.
You can't iron polyester.
You got to go steamer. That
it doesn't look that wrinkly to me. Is that
it's
just
not
me?
Wrinkly.
It's
not
wrinkly. No. Yeah, it's like folded.
Yeah,
I don't know.
Yeah, I was just confused. That's not the first comment we've seen about it needing to be ironed. That's why I had to clarify there.
You can see it was folded. There's like one crease, nipple.
Yeah, I mean, it was
fresh out of the plastic.
Actually, it was folded because it definitely came in a package. But it's been hanging up. Mm-hmm. I even put it in the shower room with me.
Oh, smart.
Yeah. Well, obviously not smart enough. You know what? The next person who talks about
you ban him.
Yeah, you know what?
Where the mods at?
I got a super good focus on a middle finger headed your way, courtesy of Sony A7C. What's up now, bitches? Heck yeah. But thank you for the super chat. That's really, really cool of you. That's really awesome, by the way.
He's a good guy. Love Keith.
Yeah, Keith. Jeez Louise. So we have four samples that I sent your way via hand delivery service, and all four of them are what some people would consider to be a beverage of your tasting and your delight. Josh is using his little partner cheating. Aaron just sitting there feeding him answers. I don't know. See, who know? We don't know. Bourbon Bender. That's a name. I hope one of these Sons of Beaches wins tonight, but if someone does, please let it be Shayla. Definitely not a Sons of Beach.
You know what? Peach. I am voting for Shayla to win too.
I just want all of you guys to win. Yeah, it's hard.
I mean, regardless of who wins, Shayla is the best. That's
agreed. Thanks.
Shayra. Wow. That was weird. Like, I was so excited for tonight that I got nervous. And I'm, that's weird. It's very strange. 688 people looking at me. Man, I'm comfortable enough in my own sexuality to say that you're looking pretty good tonight. You're looking good too, guy. Looking forward to the festivities. I can't see you, guy, but I would imagine you're looking friggin' dope.
What'd you say?
Flexman 101, don't let anyone tell you different. You are rocking the S out of that shirt. Thank you. We have a nosing round and a tasting round. And then after the tasting round, we have an additional tasting round, which is typically a bottle guest round, and we'll get to that when we get to that. So during the tasting round, don't drink all of your sample in the first tasting round, which would be, you know, 30 seconds of you just slamming an ounce of whiskey. I don't put it past some of you, Sean, but the rest of you, you know, take it easy, save some for the second round of sipping. This year, we have, this is where we're getting to. This is called Matt Madness Season 3 Hardcore. And what I didn't explain to anybody yet is what hardcore means. It means there's going to be some changes and they're going to be hardcore. Every single round, you will have the opportunity to be hardcore. And that's pretty cool. So let me explain this. Each round, each day, each time might be different. But tonight, you will have the opportunity to be hardcore. When you're answering a question, this is very important that you listen. You will have the opportunity one time to be hardcore. And what that means is, if you send your answer into chat and you put hardcore next to your answer, a correct, you will double your points for that one guess.
Whoa. Oh, hang on. Into chat? Like
the
in the main answer. Chat. Yeah, yeah, so yeah. Everybody can see.
I'm gonna send it into chat. Good luck, bitches. That's how hardcore I am. Chandler's like, I didn't get that answer. Be like, I sent it in chat. Okay, is it once per nosing and?
Nope, once per game.
One total. Okay.
One total. So if you're pretty confident and you feel like you want to get hardcore, then do it. But let me also say this. You're not the only one being hardcore. No. My rules are hardcore. And the people around you also tasting could also be hardcore. So here is the catch. Mm. If you use your hardcore answer and somebody else uses their hardcore answer during the same question, you both don't earn points.
No points?
No points will be awarded to either competitor who uses a hardcore answer if they do it in the same question. So,
have you told Shayla about this?
No. This is so awesome.
She's just as confused as we are.
Okay, so Matt, for clarity, is that they cancel it out no matter what, or they cancel it out if you both get it right?
No, if you say hardcore and somebody else says hardcore in the same question, which is like, it's like the possibilities are pretty slim that this is going to happen. But it's like, are you confident in your tasting and nosing ability to not be hardcore? You can just win it outright, or do you have to actually risk it? Like, what if?
Or like a tank. You're so confident.
Yeah. So this game is called, I had a good name for it. Oh yeah.
Great
this
title.
Hardcore round
Great
is called, title. This hardcore game tonight is called Double and or Nothing, because if you doubled with somebody, then you'd get nothing. It made sense in my head until I had to actually say it out loud. Just forget about the name and just remember the rules. That's all I got to say about that.
Pretty easy. It doesn't sound like there's a penalty for going hardcore and getting it wrong. Is that correct?
No. If you get it wrong, if you are miserably bad and you guess an answer wrong, then you will double zero. And going back to calculus, I would say that zero times two equals zero.
So it's doubling whatever points you would earn on that question. So if we double, correct. If we go hardcore on a bottle guess, mm-hmm. it would double those points.
It would. Okay. But am I going to even ask a bottle guest question? You don't know that.
I thought that's you don't know what round of tasting was for.
I said, we'll get there when we get there.
It's year three, Sean.
Hey, I've got to clarify rules, because I work with Daniel, who, if I don't clarify rules, we get to the end. He's like, oh, I thought you meant this. And was like, clearly not, buddy. Clearly not.
Fair.
Now, this is the double and or nothing round of hardcore. Just this game. There are several different games of hardcore rules I have laid out for the tournament. D's Bourbon says that rule is dumb. Well, you can.
Thanks, thanks, Darren.
Appreciate your money, though.
Darren.
Where we got Darren? What about Darren?
Nothing. Fine.
What?
Somebody asked if you could put the names up.
Channel names.
Channel names. I got you.
Is that what you're looking for here? That's what we're doing?
That's what somebody asked.
Yeah, absolutely. If any of your names are stupid, I will immediately remove them. Okay, let me see. Jesus Louise, where on earth is the thing that says...
In your ass. I'm never going to get to play this game.
I was getting and then the whole... I don't even know where to add them. They put them in the stupidest place. Where is it at? Somebody help.
I don't know how to do it, actually.
Show display names.
There it is. Jeez. Boom. There it is. There it is.
We're the only ones that didn't put our name on our channel.
You want to edit it? You can edit it if you want.
Yeah, it's fine. It's all good. I'll get it next round. I'll get it right next round.
If you like blind reviews by two wonderful people, Stuff and Whiskey, somebody drop a channel link now.
Do it.
Joe says, any chance we can increase the volume of everyone? That's not an option here. They don't allow it.
There is a button on the side of your phone, Joe.
Ah.
She's got you there.
I wasn't going to go that hardcore. But Hollywood, great intro and songs, awesome shirt. Thank you. And Christine Vasco, hardcore parkour, best time of the year. Absolutely. Oh, boy. The Bourbon Noob, for the love of God, now Heather is singing the hardcore song from School of Rock over and over. That being said, Team Perry, all the way. All right. I think we should get into the nosing round, the first nosing question. Are you guys ready for this?
I've been ready, Matt.
Let's do it.
All right.
Starting with sample D.
Grease style.
Oh, speaking of that, there was, I didn't even bring this up. 2 weeks ago, there was a Grease-themed flight that I told everyone was Grease-themed. And then at the end of it, I didn't tell everybody what the theme was. I just ended it.
I know what the theme was.
The theme was there was no theme because that was the easiest thing to do. But I just forgot to tell everybody.
There's a theme in broadcast.
I was like, if Grease had a theme, what would it be? And he'd be like, there's not a theme. I just told everybody there was. So that's obviously.
Oh, that's good.
Effing Grease. Yeah,
well.
I love that guy.
Jeez Louise. You know, I'm way too far behind to actually get deep into this. Guy. An Irish design as on a ring of two hands holding a crowned heart that symbolizes friendship, loyalty, and love. Well, that is lovely.
So if you're a girl, you can wear it like two different ways. So if the heart is out, it means you're single. If the heart is like towards you, it means you're in a relationship. It's an Irish thing.
What would you do for a crowned down guy?
I've got mine on.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah, cool. How about that?
Early Matt Madness, just enough time for a fine Alec Bradley cigar and a whiskey and an Agent Orglen. Old man Joe, you're way ahead of me. But yes, this stream is brought to us by our fine sponsors, Aged and Or, which we had a Matt Madness Agent Or glass for sale today, and it didn't make it till late. It sold out really, really quickly. But I think they're going to be making more. All right. Are you guys have your samples poured?
Yes, sir.
Ooh, we got a little Agent Or action there, Sean.
Yeah,
nice.
I travel with mine, but apparently I didn't wash them last time, so we will not be using that.
Well, treat your glasses like you treat yourself, and never shower. Just joking. Boom.
Try not to.
Boom, 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 boom. Boom. Roasted. Sorry, but not. Can't help it. WJK, cheers to the kickoff for another Matt Mattis for the focus one, the Cameron Rocks. Sheila is the bomb. Josh for the win. Hardcore. Yes. I think I'm going to actually dig the people just saying hardcore. I like it.
It sounds like parkour.
Yeah.
It does. It does.
Hardcore.
All right. So, did I type in the questions I did last night? I typed in. I'm so smart. Everything is going swimmingly. swimmingly, you could say.
Right on track.
We are going to nose glass A. And the question, which is worth 3 points, nosing only, was sample A finished in a toasted barrel? Was it double oaked in a secondary charred oak barrel? Or is this whiskey not finished at all? When the music begins, you may begin nosing. You have the entire length of the song to nose this whiskey. When the music is over, you put it down and don't pick it up again. Throughout the until I tell you to pick up sample A again. We've had some issues with people not understanding that you can't compare glasses, which is total rookie shit. And I know that none of you are in that boat, but that boat apparently is sailing somewhere and it ain't around here anymore. That's not my problem. Unless, of course, you make it my problem, in which case I'm captain now. All right, let's do this. Let's get a little music going. And when the music begins, you may begin nosing. Here we go.
Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses. Sean is smothered by Dan's successes. Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses. Sean is junior high, while Dan shook flesh. Sean's a poor guess, skinny tall man. Frosted hair, tips, milky skin, never gets a tan. And I ain't gonna lie, I heard this crazy jest. Dan wins so much he tattooed his name on Sean's chest. Now he can't sleep, he can't hold still. He's in Matt Madness with Jimmy McGill. He's here to win, Sean won't try to retire. Cause the last time he tried that, Sean got fired. Four guesses in his eyes, Sean is the one with an epidermal layer that's never seen the sun. Sean's in too deep, been through the fire. He's the world's friendliest Midwest vampire. Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses. Sean is smothered by Dan's successes. Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses. Sean is junior high, while Dan shook flex.
All right, glasses down. That is a great song. That is a good one.
Love it.
That is Sean's four guesses.
Hey, Maddie.
I like it.
Yes?
Is there a way to turn up the volume of other people? I guess like a bunch of people are talking about it. It wasn't just that one guy. I don't know how to turn the volume up of other people, but they said you're fine, but everybody else is kind of quiet. I don't know.
One sec.
I'm not sure.
Hmm.
I mean, I'm at almost 70%. So.
Okay. Mine's max, so this is as loud as we get.
Sorry, I mean, guys.
I could crank the mic up here, but we'll I'd probably have to get into the camera.
Loud noises. Everybody just yell.
Get in here.
No, there you go.
Let's see here. Do you have on the bottom of your StreamYard, I can't remember what it looks like when you're guest, but do you have a settings option on the bottom of your StreamYard?
Uh-huh. Yep.
Yeah.
If you click that and go to audio, yep. There's a thing that says automatically adjust mic volume. Is that checked in yours?
Yes.
Oh, snap. Oh, yeah. But it says I'm at 100.
All right, now I'm at 200. So
uncheck it? Do we uncheck that or?
Mine's checked.
Okay.
I just ripped her to max.
Okay.
I just turned it on automatic.
Good luck.
Mine's on automatic. We can take it off and set it manually if we need to.
I think we'll be okay now. Maybe it's better.
Oh, now people are saying it's too loud.
Oh God, Jesus. Well, okay, sorry. I shouldn't have said anything. Damn it. Okay.
Good Lord.
Oh my word. Well, we can't do everything right. Nothing around here is ever easy.
Listen, we're trying our best here.
Yeah, I did say that everything was going great.
Oh no. Oh, dude. We're having so many malfunctions.
Well, there's one unexpected nipple for tonight.
The first of many, Perry. The first of many.
There are things you can't unsee, and that kind of Friday. One of them.
Oh, that video. So good.
I mean, that lives forever.
Oh. You know?
And yeah. I'm excited about that.
He did it. I mean, makeup and all. God save that man for doing
the
that.
The confidence of it was just so impressive.
How many nipples I had to edit out in that little run through though. It's bad.
It tastes so funky, like it's either craft or finished.
that was the wrong one because there's clearly a nipple you missed.
there are things I couldn't get out. Like I would have had to crop in more, and after a while I was like, "It's dude nipples. YouTube would be fine with it."
Whiskey Mutant with a $20 super chat says, "Avenge me, Daddy." # this is my Perry Pappy. Jeez. Perry Poppy? Is that what it is? Perry Poppy?
Yeah, like Poppy. Like I Poppy. Yeah.
Like what?
Nothing.
Let's like, I'm Bobby.
Yeah, there we go. Thank you.
Yeah.
Sounds better.
Aaron, you're not allowed to say stuff like that.
Don't let
Matt's going to get demonetized.
Chicken Nugget says, let's go, Sean.
Get out of here, Peppa.
Solid name.
Solid name.
No one hates Chicken Nuggets.
Bourbon Junkies says, onlydans.com for more. Don't click that. He says, don't click it. That makes sense. Probably a bad idea. 814 people here. Holy crap. That's Dang. Insane. That is incredible. And according to the score sheet, then you probably should, well, you're making, you'll make 814 people very, very unhappy. Because according to the score sheet, you didn't even guess. That's okay.
Good. Good stuff.
Cat, no.
All right. What's going on? The cat?
Cat is trying to attack the camera. She's a long cat. See?
And the first unexpected butthole of the evening.
Yeah.
The first of many, Perry.
Thanks, John. There's some nostalgia.
She just senses the camera's on him and like hasn't been on my desk all day. And now she's do this. Cats.
Okie dokie.
There's some nostalgia.
It is some nostalgia. That's what I think. So
if you haven't hit the like button, why don't you go ahead and take a little break out, hit the like button, help Matt out. Do the thing.
Yeah, I like that idea. That's a great idea. That is a great idea. Thank you, Sean, for mentioning that. We are going to get into the second nosing question. The second nosing question is for sample B. And when you are nosing sample B, I would just like to know the age of this whiskey based off the smell of this whiskey. You'll earn 5 points for correct guess, 4 points for being 1 year off, and as little as 1 point for being up to 4 years off. Jayla's getting really good at this stupid system. I might just change it one of these days. So it's like a different scoring.
I've finally got it. Now it's
Yeah, time to change it.
Yeah. It's like the layout at efficient. Walmart. Like you go into Walmart and you go to where the bread's at and you're like, why am I looking at soup? And then you're like, they did this on purpose. So now I've got to scroll through.
Specifically to mess with you, too.
Yeah.
So you have to look at other stuff to find the damn bread. Son of a bee. They're super smart.
Why am I looking at soup?
Well, I mean, they do it. They do it all the time in the middle of the night. They jack up their aisles and they move them around.
I love that line so much.
All right, I'm going to play some music. Shayla, I'm going to put you in the background for a few, okay?
Okay, sure.
All righty.
yeah, get the people what they want.
I'm good. Four rounds the back.
We just shot up to 1,200 people.
So that was a lie.
my bad. Super sorry. All right, when the music begins, you may begin nosing glass B. Let's do it.
Perry, Perry, how can I defend you? Your podcast name is as long as a menu. You might think it's easy to write a song for a podcast name 8 or 9 words long. Perry has got podcast. This is my bourbon podcast. This is my bourbon podcast. This is my bourbon podcast.
All right. Glasses down. Answers in. Glasses
down. Five answers words in. Long. Golly. Sorry, David.
He always exaggerates stuff.
But he's not wrong.
I don't like that one.
When I first started the show, I had somebody tell me that the name was equal parts lazy and creative, and I just kind of ran with that because it's true. So,
I mean, it's very accurate. Nobody can ever
no, it is. It is. Don't get me wrong. But that's the same kind of energy that got me my undergrad degree in 7 years. So.
Hey, if you ask Ann, me too. Still to this day, he thinks it took me 7 years.
Everybody says that needs to be the new intro to my podcast.
That's pretty good.
I don't know if I can actually, well, maybe I could put it on YouTube, but because it's parody. But
thewhiskeychannel.com. Who is who?
Who dat?
Shit. I have a feeling Aaron's going to correct me on this one. Who are the creators of which songs they be singing? Try to not end the sentence in a preposition. I don't even know what preposition. It's fine. I don't even know what that is, but I don't want to do it. We love you, bud.
Oh, English. Yeah.
So if you love the music, show thewhiskeychannel.com some love. Go over to their Patreon, sign up for the Patreon, and just be like, hey, freaking love you guys. Thank you for making Matt Madness fun. Because without thewhiskeychannel.com, I don't think it would be even nearly even close to fun. It would just be like Jeopardy music, and nobody wants that again. Especially the owners of that song, apparently. They weren't happy. Zach Jones, this is going to be read before it's read, actually. First time ever. I'm going to do it, but...
It's good.
I was going to cheer for Sean, but saw Aaron and Josh. Got to cheer for the home team. Hashtag, my choose, my hoochie's Harry.
That part, though, huh? All right.
You pre-screened the wrong part, Matt.
Flip it.
Embellish pod. It's too late for financial influence. Outcome of Perry's fair. Yeah, well, no, not yet. But
plenty rounds left.
Hey, my tip jar is always open.
Is it?
No.
No. You should lock it because I'll come by and snag it from you.
Yeah, I had a guy do that once, and yeah,
pepper.
What a jerk move. What a jerk move. Todd Ritter. I missed Todd Ritter's super chat. Todd, I'm sorry. There it is. Matt, you like $1 million. I sure as hell do like $1 million. Good luck, cousin Perry, Josh, and Sean.
Love you, Todd.
Todd, I missed it. I'm trying to do my best here. You know, trying to talk over everybody unnecessarily while reading chat, playing music, finding clips that meet the situation correctly, which it's sometimes do, most of the time don't. But, you know what they say. Nobody wants to finish it.
Was there more to that? Because I don't know what they say.
I was waiting for you to tell us what they said.
Yeah.
I don't know. We'd have no idea. But let's get two samples.
Having a great time.
We gotta get because
we got pretzels.
I'm just here so I don't have to get fined.
Yeah. As Grease would say, what did Grease say last year about nope, you're killing my buzz on a Friday night but not letting me drink or something like that? Nobody kills my buzz on a Friday night. If I had the clip, I'd play it, but I don't. So let's get to sample C because it does nosing out of the way. Nosing out of the way. Before I play the music, I should probably tell you what your question is. Because that's a super smart idea. Nosing only sample C is a product of what Kentucky distillery? This is a 4-point question. What Kentucky distillery is, does this whiskey come from? When the music begins, you may begin. And remember, you do have your hardcore option to double your points if you so choose to use it. But if you use it at the same time as somebody else uses theirs, you both earn 0 points. Which is a twist and also not fair. But guess what? You'll soon learn life isn't fair.
Soon?
Yeah. Let's do some music.
Well, it's Josh and Aaron from Stuff and Whiskey. So good at stuff that their whiskey's frisky. They got their noses in some glands and stuff. Josh thinks he's really funny, but Aaron's had enough. On that madness on a Friday night, a couple four glands making up this flight. Talking about mash and beating his drum. I heard Aaron whisper, Josh is really dumb. Yeah, it's Josh and Aaron from Stuff and Whiskey. Never knew how much their whiskey stuffing meant to me. And I'm watching them here on a Friday night. Josh is struggle bus, but Aaron's got it right.
All right, glasses down. That's what I did last year. I kept trying to figure out the right layout I had for like when the timer's on. But what I did last year is I just eliminated it and just brought it back up once in a while. Kind of like how I bring Shayla back once in a while. Hey, Shayla. just kidding.
What up?
Got to keep her on her toes. Except for not, that's not very nice.
No, it's fine. It's fine. My hair's done. I'm not eating anything, so we're good.
There's no like chili.
No, there's no chili. I did have chili a couple days ago, and I thought of you, though.
Dude, I remember you just coming out, your husband just handing you food.
I know.
Tortillas. Chili, you're just like, yeah, this is great.
Mark Emanek with a solid point. Josh is pretty quiet.
He's got his game face on. He's like in his zone.
I'm just chilling. Check it out.
Let's get close.
I'm just chilling.
In hands.
Got my special shirt on for Sean.
Oh, hey now. Ah!
You know, just hanging out with friends.
That is, I didn't even connect the whiskeychannel.com on that one.
Got a whiskey shirt on. Just,
wow.
Damn. Jeez Louise, the Buffy the Vampire Slayer shirt.
Mark said he meant the volume.
What?
No. He meant Aaron and Josh were just quiet in general.
He's also not saying anything.
Mark, can you hear me, Mark?
Ooh.
Well, that's why their microphone is boomed over in the kitchen.
Are you there, God? It's me, Margaret.
Oh boy, oh boy. All right, let's do sample G, and then we're gonna have a talk about how we think we're doing.
A chat?
But what?
Hmm?
What'd you say?
A chat.
Yeah,
we're gonna chat.
We'll talk.
Okay. Can we just text
this
instead?
So what you're saying is
that was one of the greatest.
That was the greatest. Yeah.
That'll do it. That'll do it.
Every time. It's the best Sean by far.
Oh.
Sorry.
Man, I should stop because I forget how many clips of me are on the internet.
There's not that many.
Like pretzel grab mid, like.
Just. Mid thought, my brain was like, shh, 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 shh. Okay. Goodness.
Sample D, nosing only. Is sample D a bourbon, a rye, or a Tennessee whiskey? When the music begins, you may begin nosing glass D. Oh, nice SJ, Sean. Nice. Hell yeah.
I'm working on it. I've been working on the technique for
you. Truly, I learned from the master, Mr. Julian Van Winkle III, that you're aggravating that glass. You are aggravating the heck out of it. Oh. It's not wine, Sean. It's not wine.
Every time I drink whiskey, I get aggravated. It's normally around Dan, so it tracks. Yeah.
That'll do it every time.
Correlation does not equal causation.
Yeah.
It is my pleasure to welcome one and all to a brand.
We're changing. Are we changing the question?
No. I literally played it a minute and 20 seconds.
So. Oh.
So my bad. Oh. Here we go.
I see you back in the back who delivered a pack to contestants. Each one. And Shayla on screen who scores the whole thing. Well, she thinks she's the mathematical one. Oh, well, the stakes are heightening. Bring back Grizz Lightning. No matter how you face it. Oh, David is basic. Yeah.
And the mat in the back sent everyone a pack and it turned into a mat madness. And the girl off screen who scores the whole thing said it turned into a mat madness. Mat madness. Mat madness. Mat madness.
All right, glasses down. It stopped abruptly.
That was abrupt.
In that song, I can hear how much fun he's having doing that.
Oh, yeah.
He's like, neighbors.
Never change, David.
F them. I don't care about this cul-de-sac. They can, you know, just.
Hey, Matt.
The burbs.
Yes?
On the scoring sheet.
I don't have time for any negativity. I don't have time for negativity. Sorry.
Everything's hardcore this year.
Matt drops 50 new rules. Shayla's like, okay, quick clarification. Matt's like, no.
Yeah, listen, I'm not going to sit here and question me.
Shayla, you
got to
figure it out. That's what you get paid for.
That's right. All right. See, I'm sorry, Shayla. That was rude of me.
Oh, you're fine. I'm pretty sure this thing is needs to be changed. This highlighted thing that I'm 90% sure. I just want to make sure that it's correct before I change it, because I don't want to change your stuff.
Oh, what you are highlighting, you
did you have a stroke or did I?
I don't even know where I'm at anymore. No, what you don't need to change anything.
Okay. All right, cool.
You don't need to change anything at all. Okay, but thank you for keeping me on my toes, because sometimes I'm wrong and sometimes I'm right, and other times we just never know.
Most of the time you're right. Mm-hmm. I think 95% of the time you're right. So
I appreciate that. That's a ratio. That's pretty good. That's pretty damn good. All right. Aaron, how do you think you're doing?
I'm doing great. I have That's scored good. 100% of my questions. Great.
You're going. She's drinking some Sagamore Double Oak Rye. She's in her happy place, just hanging out, having a good time.
I see how it is. You have a rye within breathing distance of you. So you can kind of lean over and is this a rye? Smart. It's a smart move.
I'm just kind of Josh, how, over.
Are you killing it, Josh? You 4 for 4?
Yes.
Nice. That was
confidence.
Super confident.
When I ask my child if they wiped their ass.
Yep. And I'll take my sucker now.
Confident.
Thank you.
Yeah. We did that.
Something smells good.
Perry, did you wipe your ass? How do you think you did on your samples?
I think I don't want to be too over the top with anything. I think I did pretty well.
That's good. I like hearing that. I do like hearing
Thank
that.
Thank you.
Sean? Mr. Sidekick, as Perry would say, how do you think you're doing? Are you making your co-captain of the Bourbon Junkies happy with your performance thus far?
No, 0 for 4. Happy to be here, though.
Fell apart there, didn't they?
Oh, yeah.
I'm pretty sure that Sean does not care. And I don't know if I like that about him or not, but he just loses them. He's like, get this shit over with. We'll get it done. Put a smile on my face. Do some dabs and go to bed. Or whatever they're called.
Going hard at it, daddy.
That one's so good.
You delete that off the internet.
Funny how things on the internet live forever.
You guys say stuff that, even in context is weird, which is fine.
100%.
That's why I love you so much. Sheila, if you had to guess how they're doing, how would you think that they're doing?
No comment.
All right.
I have a really bad poker face, so I'm not going to say anything.
Anyone use that hardcore yet?
Great.
Who knows? We don't know yet. Actually, I don't even know. That's a great question. I don't even know.
I don't know. Did I?
I want to see at the end.
I don't know. That's why I asked the question, Perry.
Oh dear.
All right. I think that we have four whiskeys to taste in
dang time.
All right.
I'll stop eating pretzels.
I'm gonna need a little bit of cinnamon roll.
Cinnamon roll?
Whatever she does.
Cinnamon get roll? That blood sugar up.
Oh, I could use some blood sugar right about now. Could definitely use it.
Oh, I had a nice punschki this morning. Great blood sugar.
What'd you say?
You had a
what?
Just a Michigan thing?
I had a dream last night, and
I got any greaser in it?
I'm hoping punschkis were.
Oh, I have a question.
Personally, over here.
So, Josh, you and Grease, you shot a video together in your home. You had him in your home, brave.
After he ran an Ethernet cable through my floor, drilling straight through the bottom floor into the top floor.
And then Randy gets that cable and he's like, let's film a video.
Yeah.
He's all right, dude.
So not only did you give Grease power tools, you trusted him with said power tools.
Yeah. In our home, yes.
That's a mistake. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Actually, he did great. No complaints. 10 out of 10. Left him a good Yelp review.
Yeah. That's
awesome. He's like, I also brought you upgraded alarm clocks and smoke detectors, the things that cameras are not.
Hope you guys are like Alexa. There's three dots in your house now. Good luck finding them.
Can I interest you in a Bible read by Snoop Dogg?
Actually,
yes.
That would be amazing.
That would be awesome.
If we look, I mean, these clips are so short, so you really have to look close. But you are sitting so close together. Why? Yeah. Like,
because they're so like broad shouldered. You know, they were just taking up all the. No.
That's what it is.
Listen, there's a lot of frame to work with here. Look at this.
I think this is going to blow our ever-loving minds.
It's like, really?
You can't see that his other hand was on my leg the whole time.
He was talking about Josh's thighs a lot.
Yeah.
Fucking Grease.
And his own guns. Grease.
I mean, when you got yams like this, I can't blame him. It's all
good. I'm supposed to be up here.
Oh, my words. Let's get into the tasting round. Let's get into the tasting round. What?
What? I was talking to my cat. Sorry.
Did you say move your butt?
Yeah. It was on me.
It's weird.
Hey, I second butthole. I adjusted
when he said was it. Talking to you, Matt. Sound like he was talking to you.
Well, I did. I reacted. I did do it, but.
You take your time. You do what you got to do here,
Riddler. John. You're not my boss. Hey, this is like. Peacock feathers, all right?
Yeah.
So...
Paisley. It's called Paisley print. Don't worry about it.
Well, no, I hate this shirt.
I thought you already did. You said it didn't fit good.
No, it fits great. It's just, you know, this part.
Like, yeah.
It gets a little toit in the...
Yeah, like it doesn't fit good.
Is that what you're trying to say?
I'm just shaped weird.
Hey, Matt.
Gets jacked.
Yeah. Matt, beauty is pain. Okay, sack up, buddy. You can pull it off.
Josh told me to sack up today. And I was like, dude, I don't have it. I can't. Bruh. Like, that's impossible for me.
Bruh.
I don't think I've ever actually heard that in my life. Sack up.
I haven't until today. And now, now I've heard it twice. And it's
nut up or shut up.
That's pretty great. I've heard nut up, but not sack up.
Okay.
Sorry. Oh, Perry, calm down, okay?
He's like my virtues.
My tender virgin ears. How dare they be exposed to such vile things?
I didn't know that Josh was that rude to his wife, and she deserves better.
I can't even remember why I said it.
I don't remember either.
Moving a couch out of the basement. She's on the bottom. He's like, nut up! Come on!
Sack up. Like she entered the wrong email address for a password for a login or something.
What's your password? Sack up.
With like.
And I am a big fan of nuts. Oh, that's so good.
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
When the music begins, I want to know the age of this whiskey based off the taste. The age of the whiskey based off the palate. When the music begins, you may begin. Sean, what camera do you have at your house? Do you have like some friggin'
crazy an A6400?
Oh, okay. Is that
another
okay.
Sony?
Mm-hmm. That is that they're discontinued. Like when they're
Yeah, because it's like the 6600 is the new one that they have out for that.
Okay. When the music begins, you may begin tasting glass eye. Sorry, I'm totally into cameras now. And yeah. Oh my God.
Well, when it's rabbit hole.
I wonder why he calls his channel ADHD Whiskey.
No reason.
I love you, Matt.
I love you. But I can't play favorites, Perry. You son of a bitch.
Yeah, that's fair. That's fair.
When the music begins, you may begin tasting.
Sean says my body is milky white, you know. My skin's the color of a pearl on fresh snow. If you want Sean's body and you think he's sexy, Josh and Perry, let him know. If you really need him, just reach out and touch him. Come on, Perry, let Sean know. Sean.
Oh, let Sean know if you want his body. And as Eminem would say, look how no hands went up, or however he did it. It's in the movie. Yes. Everybody from the... So I thought, when I kind of glanced over at you, Sean, and I thought that there was a snake in the picture, but it was just a cattail.
Yeah, she won't leave me the fuck alone. So everyone gets to stream with Peppa tonight.
Oh,
headphones. Perfect. Good job, cat.
That's fine. Everywhere you go, cats just bother you.
There we go. I have headphones again. So
you can hear?
Yep.
Oh, wait. Did you take them off? You son of a bitch. Are you cheating? You taking off your headphones?
No, the cat got her with her paw. Yeah.
She is doing a thing. I'm petting my cat.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, this cat right here. Mm-hmm. Little pain in the ass.
It's all right. We still love you. We still love you.
We want.
Oh, Savannah Frisky Kitten from Whiskey Written says, Team Cat. Team Cat. By the way, we have 886 people in here, which is insanity, dang, which is incredible. Incredible. So let me take this time to say 886 of you, Stuff and Whiskey, which is Aaron and Josh. Their channel name is Stuff and Whiskey. You should definitely be subscribed to them. 100%. Perry, this is my bourbon podcast. He has a podcast, but also has a YouTube channel. And Perry and his co-host, Eric, who just a real slime ball. Because he's covered in ooze.
Oh, that's his secret.
He's a whiskey mutant. The whiskey mutant
that
himself.
That is his secret.
Yes. They all of their podcasts are also on their YouTube channel. I like watching them more than I like listening to them. I'll do either, though. But definitely... make sure you're listening to This Is My Bourbon Podcast. Do all the downloads, and wherever you're at, leave a 5-star review and subscribe. Make sure you're listening, and freaking just love. You can't not love them. They're the greatest.
We're fine.
Bourbon Junkies, they are. That's where Sean hails from, and great success. Very nice.
Fun.
Yeah, 884 of you are subscribed to them, obviously. But if you're not, then they are definitely. Dan and Sean are two of my favorite people on the planet. I would do anything for them, especially the stuff that you wouldn't think I would do.
They would.
I double down. Hardcore. You know what I mean? Whatever. Totally hardcore. Whatever. Hardcore.
Okay.
That's right.
Is sample A throwing either of you guys for a fucking loop?
Yeah.
Nope.
Okay. Perfect.
Okay. Like cool. That. Thanks,
I
Josh.
I know exactly what it is. And I'm mad at myself for my answers.
I love when... Bring him back. You know better, Sean.
What?
You know better than to talk about the samples before the.
Oh, there we go. Okay.
Before the samples are, before, that just means you're bored.
I'm just gauging their like how confident they are on sample A.
Oh. I see what you're doing.
It's
hey Matt, that focus is crisp, man.
It's crisp.
What lens do you have on that?
I think I'm hearing a very crisp shirt too.
What
something
lens
has
it
been crunching around. Yep, that's it's, your shirt, dude.
Dude, that is good.
Oh, no,
that's incredible.
Sounds a little bit rubbery.
You're not used to having focus that close to the camera, so you need some light up there because you get dark. Let's talk about it after the stream. I got you.
Let's talk about that.
I just got to get Sean. You're freaking Sean. You're pissing me off enough. You're telling me what to do. I'm calling you Sean. Jeez Louise. I know.
Like, I didn't do anything.
I get it.
Camera and light nerd too. Okay. And you didn't even text me about your new camera. Gosh.
How dare you?
Because I didn't want you to try to talk me into a Fuji.
That's valid. That's super valid.
That's all. But anyway, yeah. No, I know. I definitely need some light there. But it'll get there. I just literally plugged it in yesterday.
So we're getting light.
It looks good.
No, so no, it's the stupid. Listen.
Are you wearing leather pants, though?
Just okay.
Somebody asked if you're wearing plastic pants.
Leather pants.
Or
no, it's a stool.
Or if it was your naked thighs touching the leather.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
That's the madness. Man, that is a midlife crisis outfit if I've ever seen one.
Track Hawk is on the way, baby.
Gold chain and the the vanity plate is in the mail.
I'm trying to diversify.
That's all I'm trying to do.
I'm here for you, buddy. I'm here for you.
All right. Listen.
What round are we on?
People in chat, and I'm super excited about it. But also, I want to say this. Since there are 900 people here, I want to say that this stream is sponsored by Age Denor, the finest glassware on the planet. They are the official glassware of Matt Madness. And if you're not using Age Denor stuff, then you silly. They got amazing stuff, built great, fucking perfectly perfect. Everything's great from Age Denor. I use their bottle flight kit a lot. Every time I travel, these guys come with me every time. Look at, yeah, see that? You can see that now. Chris. And you can do this to it, nothing.
There's no way that didn't break.
If not that, this something.
Matt,
the thing that Matt forgot is that he not only lost weight this year, but he gained strength. Right. So.
And I think that's, I'm pretty sure it's a concrete floor.
Concrete. Oh. A little plastic chipped off. I spiked that sucker.
Like, but it sounded like it exploded.
Okay, boom. That's it. That's it. From a spike. Still sealed, by the way. Still sealed. Would I bring this on an airplane still? Absolutely. 100%. 98%.
Keegan's like, please don't do that.
No, it's literally sealed. That was a spike on a cement floor. I was that confident that it would still hold whiskey. I will pour whiskey in it and hold it over my face. I do that anyway. Doesn't really matter. Anyway, also, this stream is brought to us by Alec Bradley Cigars. And you can throw those on the floor too. But if you do, you're dumb. Because you should be smoking them. Unless you're the dumbest people on the planet. Alec Bradley. Smoke them or you're dumb. I think that's their new catchphrase.
Yeah, I think that's the new one that they're rolling out this year.
It's Ricky Bobby, and if you don't, you big red.
It did sound like it shattered. I thought it did too.
It did, dude. It really sounded like you decimated that thing.
But it's just that. Oh, wow. That's it. That's all it was. All right. Let's do sample B. Let's do the B. You did sample A, right?
Yeah. Yes.
We already did that. We should move to sample B. 899 people in here didn't even lose anybody with a demo. That's pretty good. What do you got there, Sean? You're agitating it without agitating it.
It's a habit from Dan's Glens because like when he washes them, his water smells terrible. Mm-hmm. So now I just do this.
Hmm. You're coating the inside of the glass like a smart person.
So that it doesn't smell like glass.
So it doesn't smell like glass.
Well, his glass smells like shit. So
like lime.
Yeah.
And iron.
Yeah. Got that bad city water, country water. Sorry.
Just got a text from Keegan that said don't.
And that was the last stream ever sponsored by Age and Norm.
No, it still worked. It still worked.
Just kidding. It wasn't. That'd be funny, though. They don't watch this, guaranteed. But if they did, they'd be happy to know that I risked it all and just a little plastic. That's it. That's all. When the music begins, I would like to know this about sample B. Talking to the cat again?
Yep.
Silly cat.
Tricks are for kids.
Hasn't been down here in three days. But
a long time.
Oh, today's the day.
That's 8 years in cat time.
What's that? Ooh. What's that disease that Joe Rogan used to talk about all the time that you get from cats? You have that?
I don't know.
Oh, the toxicity thing?
Mm-hmm. Toxoplasmosis?
That's, oh, yeah.
No.
Yeah.
No,
but that's from being around like litter for 2 weeks.
Yeah, it's changing their litter.
Yeah,
it's pregnant chicks get it.
Yeah, it's real bad.
Mm-hmm.
Well, geez Louise.
Now you know.
The more you know.
I've been trying to diagnose Sean for years personally, and I can't do it.
It's a mix of stupidity
and
ADD.
Carter said it's crabs.
Alrighty. Sample B on the palate. Is this a product of a Jim Beam, a Heaven Hill, or a Wild Turkey? When the music begins, you may begin tasting sample B. Nice little SJ. You coated it ever so nicely. You didn't even agitate it at all. Then right at the very end, Julian Van Winkle III would be so frustrated.
Oh, yeah. It's not folding in any air. It's just coating the glass. Just coating the glass.
All righty. Let's do it.
Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses, Sean is smothered by Dan's successes. Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses, Sean is junior high, while Dan shook flesh. Sean's a Borges, skinny tall man, frosted hair tips, milky skin, never gets a tan. And I ain't gonna lie, I heard this crazy jest. Dan wins so much he tattooed his name on Sean's chest. Now he can't sleep, he can't hold still, he's in Matt Madness with Jimmy McGill. He's here to win, Sean won't try to retire, cause the last time he tried that, Sean got fired. Four guesses in his eyes, Sean is the one with an epidermal layer that's never seen the sun. Sean's in too deep, been through the fire. He's the world's friendliest Midwest vampire. Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses. Sean is smothered by Dan's successes. Sean's four guesses, Sean's four guesses. Sean is junior high, while Dan shook flex.
Glasses down.
I feel like you get a new little taste every time. Like a new,
get a new what?
From the song. You just get new little nuggets of goodness every
little
time.
Little tidbits. Ooh, this is an aged in or friggin'
light board flight tray thing.
This is an aged in or, yeah, it's their flight, You know, their names of them, they could work on the names because I could confuse them the names, that's all. But I almost flipped this upside down. I was afraid.
I thought you were going to.
Because like, they have the rubberized things on the bottom of them, so that, and look at they're lettered. My dishwasher could use a friggin' talking to. By the way, these things are not very clean, pretty cloudy. But yeah, like they're friggin'. You can see that they're lettered and stuff, which is amazing. At the bottom, and they got like little, what do you call it? Things that hold them in, rubber bands, like hair ties for glasses. It's a flight set, pretty awesome. It's from Agent Orr as well. And normally I demonstrate by flipping it upside down, and I almost did that. And that would have ended up with me being wet. Wetter than normal. Which one did you say was confusing you, Sean? A?
Mm-hmm. I don't like that question that you asked there either. So
question sucked, Matt.
Yeah.
I liked it.
I didn't like your answer. So
probably
we're right
not.
There together. We are right there together. Oh, geez. You know what's funny is I didn't even mention this. Adriana, Whiskey Mountains, is tracking Super Chats. If I don't read all the Super Chats, I'm very sorry. I'm trying to read them all. But I'm sorry, DC. DC is being a proprietor, that's a word, of a giveaway tonight of an ECBP A123.
Ooh, give me an honor.
A proprietor. So every $5 Super Chat gets you entered into that. Adriana, thank you for keeping track of them. I got so much stuff going on, but DC, thank you for doing that, my man. You're the best. I want to look at the scores, but I don't. But I'm going to. Okay.
I'm caught up too.
Ooh, somebody show me the scores real quick. I won't tell anybody. Show them to me.
Hey, just show me the answers real quick. No.
You look quite.
Whatever you have guessed, you should probably guess otherwise.
That's what I feel.
Yeah, that math checks out.
But I don't. You don't know who I was talking to. Could have been talking to any one of you, or three.
I feel
of
that
you.
Way.
Or all of
or
us.
Four of you.
I'm feeling pretty good.
Oh well. Cheers to you, sir.
Shayla's doing pretty well comparatively to the rest of you guys. Not bad at all with her score of 0. Not bad. Are you eating pretzels, Sean?
Yeah. Is it allowed? Sorry.
No, not at all. I didn't hear him. I must have heard it, actually. Otherwise, I wouldn't have known.
That's just your chair, Matt. Blowing?
I don't.
What was that from? I don't hear. Huh?
Just in case you got snappy. Just in case you got a little snappy.
Mm-hmm. That's fair.
Sometimes when you end a word or a sentence like at the right time, it sounds like something different.
I get it.
Kind of like this one. This is like Perry. I obviously cut Perry off, and I'm sorry, but like obviously he was in the middle of saying something totally different, and I took him out of context.
Cowabunga!
I really want to know what stream you got these ones from.
I don't even remember.
Perry mixed a bunch of different alcohol with bourbon, which was
Why I don't remember, because it was too. Because woo, that was a good time. Go watch that.
No, I'm not going crazy.
Stag Junior will do that to you too.
Yeah, this is like Stag Junior Perry.
Really,
it'll happen. Whiskey Edition says, I'll jump in for you all. Then Tony Bag Donuts, oh yes, please, good luck, guys. But really still, Perry, Rob M, here, here's $10. At least my beach of an ex-wife won't get it.
Oh, no.
Didn't proofread that one. Mm-hmm. Sounds like your vibrator.
Who said that? Oh, my God, Rob.
Oh, God. We say some dumb shit.
And... listen, you say so much dumb shit that I didn't even find the good stuff, I'm sure. You know what I mean? Perfect. I found just random things. Mark Emmenecker, hit the like, most entertaining series on WhiskeyTube. Thanks, Mark. Yeah, hit the like button if you haven't already. Let's get into sample
C.
That's where I was headed. Thank you. Appreciate the, you know, looking out. What is a proof of sample C? You'll earn 5 points for the correct guess, 4 points for being within 3 points for being within 5, 2 points for being within 7, and a point for being even 10 proof points off, which is really good. The way I look at it.
You're so
Sean will do hardcore and get 2 points.
Hardcore or zero.
Nah, I have faith in you.
I'd be within 10. Shit, why would I not?
In either direction, which is nice. In either direction.
Ooh,
I got a shoulder issue. Oh.
I think it is the shirt. I don't think it's your chair.
No,
bro.
It's been there.
No.
It's been there.
That's not what I'm talking about.
It's closing in on him.
There's this, like, scrunching noise that keeps coming from
you. Yeah, it sounds like rubbery.
God damn it.
I don't think it's your chair. No, it's your shirt, bro.
And not your butt, and it made the noise.
Yeah, it's your butt.
Okay, well, now you're not sitting on it. Move your arms around.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it is the chair.
See?
Oh. Yeah, you're right.
Listen.
Just helping him figure this out.
I'm not so too paranoid.
Thanks for tuning in for the troubleshooting.
He just moves his butt the same time he moves his arms. They're like linked together.
That's why we're on this first stream for Matt Madness, is because we all notice different things, and we're all trying to make sure that the next round is better than this one.
Quality control.
Exactly, yeah.
Yeah. It's my fault for trying to be proper and wearing jeans. Normally I'm bare ass on this thing. So
hey, you're doing the Lord's work,
that,
buddy.
That was onlydans.com.
Listen,
when I pivot my hips, oh, tonight, you know, my hips don't. But she didn't do it.
What?
That one didn't do it.
There you go.
No. That just sounded like, never mind.
So sample C, tell me
Let's
about
do
it.
C.
Yeah, tell us about it, Matt.
I need a standing desk, don't I?
Oh,
no.
Don't we all?
These streams are too long.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
When the music begins,
I'm standing up.
Yeah, you're not gonna want
David and Kira stand their entire stream.
I know. I don't know how they do
We're
that.
Savages.
I don't understand.
And David still has no ass. So weird.
We just standing. He's not squatting.
Okay. The music begins. You may begin tasting. Sample C.
Perry, Perry, how can I defend you? Your podcast name is as long as a venue. You might think it's easy to write a song for a podcast name 8 or 9 words long. Got a podcast. This is my bourbon podcast. Yes.
This is my bourbon podcast.
This is my bourbon podcast. Yes.
This is my bourbon podcast.
All right. Glasses down. Answers in, everybody. Answers in. And Shayla will be plugging those in to the spreadsheet of doom, as we like to call it, which I don't ever, I've never called it.
The first time for everything.
Man, it's still 900 people in here. I am over the moon with the turnout tonight. Incredible. Incredible, everybody. Thank you. And please come back the next week and the next week and the next week too. This makes me so happy. And please spread the love to the other channels. Stuff and Whiskey. This is My Bourbon Podcast. And Whiskey Central, Shayla, please go subscribe to their channels and spread the love, because nothing makes a dopamine spike like clicking on the old YouTube studio and seeing the subscriber number jump, especially when you have Sean on your team and all, everything is working against you. Dan would have 300,000 by now. Sean's there for negative 200K. And it's, you know, right.
I like to think I really ground Dan, so y'all are welcome.
Man, I'm such a jerk. I promised you not that long ago that I was done being a jerk.
But did I believe you? Not so much.
It's because I love you. And I think that it's good to have a Toby, if we were talking an office
there.
No. Oh, man, that clip. Yeah, Toby's back. No, he's not.
Yeah, that was good. The office is the bomb.
David says, it's this young 45-year-old body of mine. That lets him stand that long? I would imagine. Solid, probably. His feet are probably sore. What kind of sneakers do you think he wears? New Balance?
Skechers.
Yeah, Skechers.
He's a Skecher guy.
He's a Skecher kind of guy, 100%.
Like, started with a memory foam and now they're flat.
Yeah.
Yep.
For Matt's Tulsa King shirt collection fund, what the hell is Tulsa? Do I even want to know?
It's some like show with Stallone or something, right?
Yeah.
I haven't seen it, but...
The Taylor Sheridan show. He's the guy that wrote or co-wrote Yellowstone. So he can write anything and people will pick it up now.
Now I'm hearing the squeaking every time I move. I'm trying not to move.
It's me. I've just been fucking with you the whole night.
Red light.
Yeah, red light.
Damn it. I'm gonna squat it now.
Ooh.
That is get that squeaking.
Ass. No, it's
okay. Crap. I'm frustrated. Jeffrey Wax in the house. Matt Madden's competitor, Jeffrey Wack, has realized I've been watching Matt knock down Sean since 2019. I've been trying to get Dan to fire him for this long, and now they're literally partners and can't be. It's too late. Now it's too late.
There's still time.
Mazel.
One WD, hashtag BJ Vampire. Wow, that sounds like it would hurt.
Intriguing.
You know what I mean?
Oh.
What? Like something I'd like to invest in. I mean, yeah. What?
I didn't know that you could put a stake through the heart through that orifice. You know what I mean?
That's, oh, boy.
Long stake. Ben Leek, what about a drawing for that magnificent shirt? I'll sell a fucking shirt. Pardon my life.
He's been selling underwear for years on OnlyDams.com. He'll sell a shirt.
It's more of like a
Mama Porter. Are you still in the chat?
Not now.
Hello, Kitty.
She just shook her head and looked around the room like, "Who else heard that?"
She went, Matt.
"My dad's snoring for sure," and nobody else heard it. So, did it really happen? Yeah. Never know. Jay Porter, solid last name, kind of dig it.
Your brother. Matt's
wearing pink Crocs.
Show them kicks.
Oh, just slides.
Got them and one slides.
$3 at Walmart. No big deal.
Okay, so the picture is becoming a little clearer. It's midlife crisis in Miami.
One gold chain away.
One gold chain away in a vanity license plate.
Yes, we need to put you in like a vintage Lambo or Ferrari too. That'd really top it.
Yeah. A Countach.
Oh yeah.
He's a Countach guy.
Maybe a Thunder.
Monaco. Wolf of Wall Street here.
We've settled for a Vanbo. The Vanbogini is just sounds really sick now with like five cylinders firing, right? It's great.
Hi, Mama Porter, by the way.
Yeah, mom's in the house, everyone. 923 people with my mama. We're on sample D now, huh?
Yard.
Is that true? Yeah. All right.
Yard.
This is a question that I would like to know the answer to. So when the music begins, I would like to know, Perry, what are you drinking? Is that Liquid Death?
Yeah, it is.
Really?
I'm double fisting the sparkling water and the still.
The what?
The sparkling water and the still.
I'm trying to diversify.
Oh, that TV static in a glass?
Yeah.
Bless you guys and your sparkling water.
Whoa, Ryan Alves. Come in.
Hot. That man.
Coming in hotter than a friggin' Ryan Alves. You gangster, I friggin' love you, dude. Thank you so much for being the person you are. Long distance BFF. 15 Nulu picks left. I love you. I love you more. And I didn't even mention that tonight. Jeez, my brain is elsewhere. It's solidly in this tournament. But yeah, there are, if I'm not sure that DC's been rocking the thing in chat, but there are, boy, where are they at? I get so sidetracked and then I get frustrated with myself, but that's all right. There are 15 of these bad boys left. This is it's a Nulu toasted bourbon whiskey finished in apple brandy cask. It's a 6-year-old 36% rye MGP bourbon finished for 4 months in a toasted barrel and then 10 months in an apple brandy cask, 123 so proof. Excited. It's delicious. It's really, really good. There are 15 of them left. They're $99. And they are tremendous. They are so stinking good. I can't wait to get... What?
Your mom's tremendous.
She's in my the mom. Chat, bro.
It's, she's tremendous.
She is.
Oh, in a good way.
No, it almost sounds like, yeah, whenever you start with, like, your mom. It's, yeah,
no, we helped Matt Bev up at the airport. It was awesome.
She's yeah, we did. Thank you for...
Shout out to Mama P.
I'm giving you the middle finger right now with my other hand. You can't even see it.
Just mid-mat plug.
No, but anyway, the other thing about this is, see the sticker on the back, the hardcore Matt Madness ADHD Matt Madness sticker, season 3 hardcore sticker. There are 10 random stickers that are holographic in the bunch like that. If you get a holographic sticker, they're randomly placed in orders. Good to do a private virtual tasting with you and a couple friends. So 10 of you will get a holographic bottle and you'll get a virtual tasting if you want it. If you don't want it, I don't blame you, but just thought it'd be kind of fun to do with 10 random people who bought a single barrel of mine.
That's awesome.
It's like an insert in a pack of basketball cards that mm-hmm. I know, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just fun
or
shit
for the nerds, you know.
Heck
the
yeah,
awesome card in Magic the Gathering, you know.
I anyway. Never got that nerdy. When the music begins, I would like to know if this mash bill, the mash bill of sample D, contains over or under 75% corn. If you know your mash bills, then you can let the wheels run amok. But if you don't, then also let the wheels run amok. Does this mash bill have over or under 75% corn? Josh?
What if it's 75 on the dot?
Then I wouldn't have asked the question
terrible,
over or under 75.
He would have said 74.
I've heard people handle that in a different way.
That's a fair question. He might be trying to be tricky.
I liked the question. I didn't have any problem with it. It was just Sean's reaction of shooting you down very quickly.
You're a shiesty fella, okay? I just want to make sure we're all on the up and up here going into
well, it makes me happy to know that I'm keeping you on your toes.
Oh, you are.
That's the wrong thing. Where the hell's my thing?
At least it's not that false start of a first round last year where none of us had samples.
That happened.
Yeah.
That definitely happened.
That was a great time. That was a wonderful, wonderful time.
I wasted your time, but I at least got consent. And
I mean, I said
that's an important thing.
Super important in 2022.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. When the music begins,
or always, we'll have the answer to that. And it's also 2023.
You know, until 2022, not important.
Come on, contextualize the comment, guys.
It happened.
I'm just going on what you said.
Yeah.
He said sexualize the comment. Is that what he said? What
a sure jerk. Did.
Oh, that's what I heard.
Oh, go ahead and take your time guessing all these blends. Before I show you stuff, we have to be whiskey friends. We wanna stuff and whiskey wanna stuff. Your whiskey wanna stuff and whiskey. I'm Matt Madness. Josh, yes, I wanna stuff and whiskey on the screen. My stuff is like no other. Matt Madness, stuffing whiskey till you scream. You never let me stuff whiskey. I'm always whiskeying my stuff. I love the stuff you whisk me. I'm no bourbon fluffer. I'm your whiskey stuffer.
Time is up. Glasses down. Glasses down. 958 people in here. If you haven't hit the thumbs up, hit the thumbs up. If we can break 1,000 people on the opening night of Matt Madness in chat, I will. I don't even have any idea. I'll be extremely happy. We're approaching my BMI. That is an old joke of mine. Now it's not as funny, but it was way funnier before when I was extra fat.
It's still good. Also, look everybody that's watching this, just share.
Look
this
at you, quiet face. Buggers.
Even if
Perry,
what?
I was just like, I'm amazed at how quiet they're being.
Yeah, I know, it's weird.
They're gazing off into space, like space had boobs.
Really thinking.
Did you ask?
Does it not?
Freaking A, man, with mash bill questions and stuff. Oh, all right.
Hey, that's welcome to the main event.
Yeah, Matt,
welcome to the main event.
Were you in my stream last night when Skeletor popped up?
Sean came in?
Here right now.
No, somebody with the name, literally with the name Skeletor, popped into my stream for a grand total of one comment that just said boob. And then he was gone.
Oh, somebody clipped that point. I think.
Solid comment, though.
Great
and
comment.
And Eric was like this or whatever.
Yeah. We've got it. There's a screen cap of it, which is really funny. But it just absolutely made my night. Anyway.
That's awesome.
I missed a super chat from Aaron Steichman. My main man. Aaron Steichman. In it to win it, hashtag Wutta Wutta. And then Toshi Baked, another super chat. Always a great Friday with Matt Madness, entertaining competitors and hilarious music from David. Sean, if you lose, you're going to have to show the Dan tattoo on your chest.
No. What was the end of that? Was that Wutta Wutta?
Yeah. Wutta Wutta Wutta. You know?
Could have been a ghost.
What?
No, I don't know.
The song with the, you know, Kira doing this.
You've never. Oh.
I'm missing this right now.
I'll send you.
I have missed the Wutta Wutta.
Yeah, it's a great video. Hold on.
Oh, whiskeychannel.com. You still team Sean?
Probably not. I don't think they ever were. I don't. Never were, so I don't know why you asked in the first place.
I am going. Hold on.
Cookie had more team Cookie than team Sean, so.
What does that even mean?
Team Cookie is the castle cat.
How am I going to find this?
You know Cookie.
Oh, I think Net Cookie. I have.
Is it the 1792 one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, come on then.
Well, dude, I have like 1,000. I mean,
no, I was talking to the cat again. She was just meowing at me. Sorry.
How would anybody know that?
No one should. And I apologize.
I don't know. If I'm, no. Feel like. Oh wait.
I feel like Sean lives by the motto of, you know what, figure it out, and then when things go wrong, he just cleans up the mess. It's kind of like Dan, the cat, you know, it's all the same.
Just go with whatever.
Yeah.
Go with flow type thing.
Just roll with it.
Sometimes I think I'll be able to find things relatively quickly, and then 4 hours later, still in bed. David and Kira. It's another David Kira jam. Michael McCune, my first ever super chat of Matt Madness. Hashtag Team Sean. Solid Team Sean. Shout out. Hells yeah.
Okay, embellish. I've watched every episode except for one of Matt Madness so far.
Team Sean? This dude has a team? Oh, sick burn. It's a good burn. That is a good, solid, sick burn.
You know what? When I lose, I still got this cat. She loves me.
Leslie Lockett sent a super sticker. Can someone tell me what the sticker is? I'd like to know. I can't see it on the side of the screen.
It's a little lemon head with hard eyes, and it's bouncing back and forth.
I like that.
kind of creepy.
I do. It's not very nice. It's a super sticker. Mr. Jiggs, let's go. Bourbon Junkies, hashtag Team Evanishon. Thanks, Matt, for bringing Disco back. Hashtag Shayla Bot needs a raise. Yeah, she could use a raise. 100%. 100%. So we've tasted all four samples, correct?
We have.
We did that.
Incredible. Incredible. I think that... Well, let me do this.
Oh, I found it.
Oh, you found it?
Yeah.
Nice. Let's hear it. My chair is squeaking.
It's the one, it's called You Only Need 5 Whiskeys, ADHD Whiskey Edition. Mm. I think that's
the one. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yep, that's the one.
Yeah.
What the?
Oh, I thought you were going to jam it.
Do you want me to play it? Oh, I can play it.
Over 1,000 people are watching this right now. Hit the
hell like. Hell yeah. 1,002. That's incredible.
What's up, y'all? Hit the like button.
That was loud. Heavenly moly. You brought 1,000 people in. Good job.
1,000 people need to hear this final song. It's a 3-minute timer.
Oh.
You have four whiskeys in front of you. You will give four answers. The final round, now you have to pay attention because these questions are a little bit different. Final round, sample A, I want to know the distillery this product came from. Guess the distillery for 4 points. Sample B, I want you to guess the age. Sample C and D are bottle guesses.
Ooh, okay.
A, distillery.
Chat, by the way.
Uh-oh.
He said boob.
Skeletor!
I'm assuming it's she. Could be a she. I don't know. I don't want to be sexist.
Yeah. Hey, they're universal. Let's
different
be honest.
Avatar from last night, but hello, Skeletor.
Sack up, Aaron.
I know, I've been told that twice today now. Apparently, I have issues.
I'm just joking. I'm just joking. Sample B, I want to know the age, and then C and D bottle guesses. I have...
Wait. Didn't we... Sorry, wasn't the first question on sample B already an age question?
Oh, yeah, it was.
Hold on.
And so it...
Oh, yeah, wait. It was. So double down or hardcore, all right?
I'm not trying to poke here. I'm just looking through my notes.
That was a nosing question, right?
Yeah. That we went.
Yeah, so now you're tasting it.
Okay. That's fair.
So
wow.
Whoa, we do get to double down on it. I'm wrong. I am totally wrong. I apologize. Sean, thank you for correcting me. I'm totally wrong. It is a proof question. It's a proof question, not an age question. So
I never thought I'd hear the day. Can someone clip that, please, and send it to me? BourbonJunk@gmail.com.
So proof.
What's that?
Not age. Proof on B, not age.
Yeah. So, yeah, I want the proof on B, not age.
Totally forgot I was muted.
Oh, I'm so dumb.
I was like,
why can nobody hear me?
I said, thank goodness somebody's paying attention, and apologies for not doing my. Literally, I have one fucking job, and I can't do it. So.
Amateur.
I sorry, Matt. I didn't mean to take you off the rails on that one.
Okay.
No, I just posted good looking out. Good looking out. That's
it could
my
have been
bad.
A double down situation. It absolutely could have been a double down situation.
It definitely could have been.
Discount double check.
That's not how the score sheet looked. Just
I was just double checking.
Sean, it says guess the proof. You see it? Why would you think I said age? It says right there. Sample B. Guess
you know,
the proof.
I'm dumb. You're smart. I'm sorry.
No, don't ever. Oh, jeez. Now you just ruined it. Nick the Greek, thank you, David, for the great songs. 100%, absolutely amazing stuff. Amazing vocal talent coming from David. Ben Leek, Team Sean, even if he thinks Irish is a country.
I had Pam wrote Irish.
And then Afidi, 1965, still waiting to see Sean's belly button piercing and crop top for losing poor guesses. Hashtag cheater.
Yeah, I love everybody was like, oh yeah, vote. And then he was like, yeah, not fucking doing that.
No, Dan is the one that typed that. Dan goes, what is number one right now? I go, no. He goes, fucking belly button ring. He goes, I already answered. He goes, not doing that.
That's you could take it out.
Yeah. But someone commented and was like, I did one like a fantasy football type thing, still have like a scar to this day. I was like, yeah. Cool. Good to know.
But look, he can take it out, but the fact that he has to go and get it in the first place,
yeah,
that in and of itself is the beauty.
That's the bad part. We hit 1K, guys.
Yeah. Cheers to you guys.
Cheers, thanks everybody.
Thanks for beating my ass, because I think I'm getting about 3 points tonight. Right. Nice, I guess. That's
3 more points than I'm getting, Sean.
So. I asked earlier, I was like, sample A would really throw you. You're like, no. Got it. No,
I scored 20 points on that one, but the rest I'm striking out.
Oh, you're pretty confident, sir.
Oh,
I like it.
Nice. All right, question before we get into this.
Kidding.
Since these are individual questions, if we were to say hardcore for one of these, would mm-hmm. that count for one of them or for yeah. the round as a whole?
One of them.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yep.
And I'm strategically placing mine.
Hang
good
on.
Luck.
Solid, you guys hardcore question.
You guys didn't use your hardcore on the very first question?
No.
Really? Okay. Never mind.
I'm not saying I'm going to use my hardcore. I just want to know the parameters for which it could
solid
be.
Solid question. Because these parameters have never been
tested. In their
parameter.
Yeah.
Or exactly. spoken out loud to anybody else other than you, Matt.
No, it's literally been just cooped up in my head, which is a terrible place to be. Just bouncing around.
You sang the entire theme of like the night and how everything worked and watching Shayla go, wait, what? How do I do that? And you were like, this is how we're doing it. Okay.
Matt Madness. Luckily, the chaos is scripted.
Luckily, it seems like she came in here totally sober. Shayla Bot was, otherwise would have been on one of these situations.
So what you're saying is
pretzel.
ECBC.
ECBC. All right. Yeah.
The ECBC.
When this music begins, you have 3 minutes to answer all 4 questions. I have the utmost faith in you.
Wrongly placed.
No. Sean, stop being... Listen, nobody else is negative about you around here except for yourself. And
of course.
But, and listen,
you.
I need
half
you
the
to...
Chat. And you and half
the chat. There's
three
nobody
more?
In here.
Did I go too low?
Oh, yeah. And Team Matt. Here, Team Matt. Thanks, Nick. And then Leslie Lockett. Now, I'm super... Listen, that's a fucking... I just said the F word again, Mom. That's a solid name. Leslie Lockett is like
she lost her pocket.
Yeah, she's never heard that before, Perry.
Oh, cool.
Jeez.
Wow. Hey.
It's like Matthew Porter needs a quarter.
Hey, I'm just trying to diversify. Or whatever the crap I said.
Pop lock. There we go.
Top lock and try. Yeah. All right. When the music begins, you may begin tasting all 4 samples. If you're ready, then I'm ready for this jammer.
Banger.
These guys have got a thing for Sean. Both these guys have got a thing for Sean. Sean, I heard that Harry wants to live stream with you. Live stream with you. But make it unlisted so that it's just for you two. Just for you two. Did Dan leave early for that business trip? Dan is so old. Can Perry meet you at the castle just for a sip? A castle sip. You know he's not the 90-pound boy he used to be. Sean's all filled at 100 pounds at 6'3". It's not wrong. Pear has a thing for Sean. There's more to this song. Josh has a thing for Sean. Sonny, can't you see admiration on my screen? There's no way this is wrong, but both these guys have things for Sean. Both these guys have got a thing for Sean. Both these guys have got a thing for Sean. Sean, your channel has had a lot of success. A lot of success.
And Josh definitely knows your physical address.
Here's your physical address.
Josh can tell you like him because of your thumbs up.
Thumbs up what?
Josh's favorite conjunction word is the word but.
Josh loves your butt.
You know Sean's not a pale boy, that I must stress. Sean uses sunblock under 80 SPF. What's going on? Josh has a thing for Sean. And Perry's turned on. He has a thing for Sean. Sonny, can't you see admiration on my screen? There's no way this is wrong, but both these guys have things for Sean.
Sean equals the great value dirt diggler. ADHD Whiskey. Sean looks like Bill Burr got into a chalk fight on day 98 of his no-calorie diet. Sean's an island boy. All y'all acting like you've never seen a man with a pathetic mustache. Get over it.
What's going on? Josh has a thing for Sean. And Perry's turned on. He has a thing for Sean. Sonny, can't you see all this horniness on screen? How could this be wrong? We all got a thing for Sean. Oh. We all have a thing for Sean. He's the most attractive guy I know. We all have a thing for Sean.
Yes! Oh my God.
That was incredible.
He is the king of everything.
That was amazing.
Like,
that's better than the original.
It's so true. How did he know? David.
I think I have a thing for Sean. Obviously, I can't stop talking about him. No, answers in, everybody. Answers in.
I got a format.
I'm pretty into dudes right now.
Also, I don't even know if you can take that out of context. I don't know if you can take that out of context or not. It's just words he said.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. WhiskeyChannel.com says friggin' love Matt Matters. Dude, that, oh my God. I can't even. I listened to that. I just. Repeat.
That
repeat.
Almost made me cry just because of how happy it made me. Like,
right. It's just a thing. It's just a whole thing.
Yeah.
I told David last night. He sent over the music and I listened to part of the Sean's Poor Guesses song and I immediately tells you, dude, I love you. Like, this is great. Like, and then I didn't even listen to the other ones yet. But after I got done listening, I texted him again and said, the fact that you're not at least VH1 famous pisses me off. Like, you should be at least at the bare minimum.
Or The Box. You guys remember The Box?
Oh, quite well.
No, okay.
I don't. Yeah, sorry.
What's The Box?
Josh, I turned 30 in August.
Oh, my God. He's okay. It was like the Canadian version of VH1.
Mm.
Oh, no.
Well, I am American.
Sorry, I didn't know it. Sorry. Mm-hmm.
Oh, that was good.
Oh, that's a solid. That's a. Mm.
Sorry.
She's really good at impressions.
Oh my God.
Matt, you're a Uber. You basically are Canadian.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah. The funny thing is when you're up there, the more you're around people who talk like that, it's just like it comes. When I was driving a bus, there is this. I can't remember his name anymore, but I was
Felipe.
Like. No, definitely not Felipe. It was, but I was talking to somebody and I was like, he is the most Finlander person I've ever heard speak in my entire life. And the guy goes, he's not Finnish. He just worked at the mine for 30 years. And he just talks like that now. Like,
all right.
Like the extreme version of like that, the oh my goodness.
He just picked it up.
Oh, he picked it up and went with it, like extra hard. That's right. 1,039 people in chat. Incredible. I'm so excited about this turnout. Like, this is crazy numbers. That's crazy numbers. I appreciate everybody so much. Thank you so much. Christine Vasco agreed David needs more fame, legit talent. He's like, that's a talent. That's a crazy talent.
Yeah. He super needs crazy to talent. Do something with that, like as a permanent job. It's crazy.
All it takes is the right person to like to hear it and see it, and just one person.
Yeah.
And then David will no longer be doing this, especially for free.
You know what I mean? Hashtag birds.
Holly Ingram, freaking awesome, guys. I agree. I'm going to take a peek at the scores and exactly how I thought this would go.
So bad.
Oh, I took dead last. Cheers, guys.
No,
thank you.
No, you did not.
For having me.
No, you did not.
I'd be willing to put real money on it.
Those are all the correct
answers. I'm not confident in any answer I gave tonight.
I
am not.
I feel pretty good about this one.
Perry, let us know how it is in the next round.
Yeah.
I feel pretty good about this one.
Cool. I was in a blender the whole time. good luck on the next round, sir.
It's pronounced Bender, and thank you.
Mm. All right.
James R. Wow. The Lantovic. Matt freaking Madness. Sorry if I butchered your last name. My bad.
I had Pepper on my lap the whole time. She's really distracting me.
Oh.
What it was.
Is that like the poor man's cinnamon? Like, is that what the strippers are called in Midland? Pepper?
Oregano was really giving me the
Pepper's the name of my cat. You
give me a reach around.
Have you guys seen Tony Shashery? She is awesome.
Who?
Perkins Jerkins.
Let's get into the scoring.
Let's not.
Shayla's saying, hold on. I am
double checking my map, and I don't think one of them is correct. So hold on.
Add a zero to mine. Like a after.
Oh, he did. Okay. Yeah,
what?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like one if it's 10.
Let me know when you know, Shayla.
Yeah, give me just like 2 minutes. I just want to double check just in case, because you know me in math.
Old Bay is a stripper name. Donnie is amazing.
Is it though?
Yeah, no, it's great. Gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Old Bay.
I just want seafood.
Yeah.
Well, you're gonna see food. Wait, what?
Get your crab legs at the buffet bar.
And let me say this, and I feel like I need to. I'm not stripper shaming. As a matter of fact, you make that money.
He's pro stripper. You know what
I mean? I'm 100% pro stripper. And if that's offensive, I'm sorry. I don't know where to stand on this issue. So I'll just get off of it.
Okay. And everything is right to the best of my knowledge, which, you know, low IQ.
That was the most well-timed interruption of my life, because what I was about to say next was not great.
I'm sorry.
Good job, Shayla.
Thank you. All right, now
we did the script perfectly.
Okay, so nothing changed.
No, but I just wanted to make sure, because there was one, and I was like, "Wait, but no, it was right." So
I appreciate your astuteness, if that is what that was.
I actually don't know what that means, but it sounded good.
I don't know what it means either, Shayla.
It's a good word.
I've used it before, and I'm not 100% sure what it means, but it's fine.
All right, I am going to pour one last pour here before we get to the score here.
If that is A, I'm going to punch you in your fucking face. What?
No.
Wow, I'm just pouring a dram, America, into my aged Nornie glass, the one I got from the Bourbon Junkies meetup.
Jeez, that's not A. That autofocus is crisp, Matt.
It's so crisp. Oh, my goodness. I want to see if the Sony.
I love hearing that every time. I got so jealous of everyone with their autofocus and me not having nothing. Like, look, I don't even have focus in my head.
Look, we're on Fuji and our autofocus. Oh, that's
nice
pretty
too.
Good.
Oh, no, but
then it switches back to our face.
Yeah. So that is the same camera that Whiskey Wimps have, by the way.
I'm on a
phone. We're shooting on a 35 millimeter Sony f/1.8. That's what we're shooting.
Oh, wow. Good for you.
It's not the art lens. No. That one was way more money.
Yeah.
What the crap? What happened?
Barry. Sony will get you those G-Master Barry's lenses. Just
totally hold on. That's what happens when you use a Logitech C922 webcam.
Oh my god, we have the same webcam, Perry.
What?
Yes! High five. High five. Yes.
Oh, I think we just smacked each other in the face.
That's true, but it's okay.
Oh yeah, all this camera talk is getting whiskey tubers hot and bothered, by the way.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And hey, there are a lot of tech nerds out here.
Definitely bothered. A lot of people are bothered right now.
I because they want to get to the score. Oh, I think I missed one. J-Bo with a $50 super chat from out of nowhere. J-Bo doesn't even say a word. Just he's wearing sunglasses and looking sharp.
That's how you do it.
J-Bo. Thank you, J-Bo. Women of Whiskeys, Shayla Bot is my hero, says Women of Whiskeys. Aw. That's beautiful.
Thank you.
That is B-E-A beautiful. Let's get to the scores. Let's do it. Bobby Shaw, it was the red hot pick, yeah. Here we go. Sample A. This is the nosing round. I asked you to nose sample A. I asked you if this was a toasted whiskey, a double oaked whiskey, or no finish at all. Sean says not finished. Perry says toasted. Josh says toasted. The correct answer was not finished. Moving to the age of sample B, I asked you to guess the age of sample B. Sean guessed 9 years, Perry guessed 7, Josh guessed 8. Correct answer was...
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. No, okay. Let's double check.
Ooh, see, this is good.
Recalculating.
I could have typed it wrong. This might screw me in the end.
80 years old.
This is my hardcore.
18 years old.
It might screw you in the end.
Blowing us.
Okay, what did I do?
Having a great time over here. Eating my pretzels and drinking my Montucky cold snack.
Okay, so what did you said 10, Josh?
Ten.
Yes?
10.
Yeah, and it says 10 right there, doesn't it, Maddie?
And that was my hardcore.
Right yeah.
Oh.
Yes, I wrote hard.
Hard.
Oh, I said 8, didn't I, Josh?
You did say 8.
Yeah.
My apologies. Josh said 10.
Wow.
Josh guessed 10 years. And he also made that his hardcore guess.
Right off
hardcore. Our first hardcore.
Hardcore.
Parkour.
Dude, that is such a mind fuck, by the way.
I know. It definitely is.
Good. That's what it was supposed to be.
Yeah.
You did a real good job with that one, Matt. You did.
Because it's like, if you're, I'm so confident about this, but if I'm confident, what if they're confident and they use the hardcore?
I sent a message that said I felt very confident about one answer and didn't use it because I thought it was an obvious answer, and I was like, I can't do it.
Well,
okay,
let's see if the first hardcore answer in the 2023 Matt Mattis Whiskey Tasting Invitational paid off. The correct answer was 2. Just kidding. The correct answer was 11. So it paid off. Josh earned 8 points with his hardcore answer.
So that's why you said 8. So
damn.
Jeez Louise. Moving on to sample C, said name this Kentucky distillery. Sean guessed Wild Turkey. Perry guessed Heaven Hill. Josh guessed a Buffalo Tross. Correct answer, Wild Turkey. Sean earning 4 points. Congratulations, Sean. Good job.
That was moving a tough one. That was like one of the hardest questions I think you asked.
It's so cherry.
Sample D, I said, is this a bourbon, a rye, or a Tennessee whiskey? Sean guessed Tennessee whiskey. Perry guessed rye. Josh guessed bourbon. Correct answer, bourbon. Josh with 3 points.
Wow.
Moving to the palate guesses, the palate jacks. We're asking, first of all, the age on palate on sample A. The age on sample A. Sean way off with 14 years. Perry with a 7-year guess. And Josh with a 6-year guess. Correct answer, 7 years. Perry friggin' nailing it. Friggin' nailing it hard. Okay. Nailing it like the carpenter nailed the great-grandma back in the 20s.
Oh, I thought you were going to say Jesus to the cross, but all right.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
That took a turn.
No. Got a little bit here.
Hey, man, I call them as I see them. I'm having a great time. Thanks for being here.
Trying to diversify.
But he was right. All right.
Okay, good. Sample B on the palate. I asked you if this was Beam Turkey or Heaven Hill. Sean guessed Heaven Hill. Perry guessed Heaven Hill. Josh guessed Turkey. All three of you were incorrect.
Oh. Dang.
It's a Beam product.
Fuck. Okay.
I even messaged Dan. I said, I felt like it was Beam on the nose. And then I messaged Heaven Hill to Sheila. I don't know why.
I thought you said you messaged Heaven Hill.
Dear Heaven Hill, please tell me like if I'm bored, right.
How bored were you? You're like,
hey, Heaven Hill, did Matt put this as number two in his guest tonight? They're like,
just
want to
let you know, I think.
Heaven Hill, you up?
You up?
They told me hard no. Are you stupid? It's like, yes.
That's so good.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Sample C, I said, guess the proof. Guess the proof. Sean said 107. Hardcore! That's the hardcore answer. 107. Hardcore! Perry guessed 98. Josh guessed 114. Correct answer, 101. Sean's hardcore answer earned him 4 points, which was the same as Perry's not hardcore answer, 4 points. Josh went extra hardcore and said, I don't need any points at all. 114.
I don't need those points.
I'm totally wrong. Totally wrong. But he will redeem himself in the end. Unless, of course, I'm lying, which is a solid, solid possibility. Sample D on the palate, I said, is this over or under 75% corn? Hardcore. Hardcore. Sean says over. Perry says over. Josh says over. You are all correct. It is over 75% corn.
Good job, boys.
We went to the 3-minute tasting round where we learned that everybody has a thing for Sean, according to David of WhiskeyChannel.com. I said, guess the distillery on sample A. Sean says Old Forester. Perry said Heaven Hill. Hardcore! This is hardcore guess.
Oh.
Josh said MGP. The correct answer,
Barton.
MGP. It's an MGP bourbon.
Snap.
Then we said, guess the proof. Guess the proof of sample B. Sean says, it's a 90 proofish. Perry said, it's around 100 proof, I would say. And Josh said, I agree with Sean, 90 proof, cheating off Sean's paper. Correct answer, Sean was cheating off of somebody who knew it, and then apparently Josh got lucky for cheating off the right person because 90 is the correct answer. You both earned 5 points, nailing the proof on the head. Nailing it, 90 proof. Great job, Sean.
Good job, buddy.
Sean, by the way, typically and historically not great on proof points ever, especially those under 100 proof.
Under 100.
No. That is a shot in the fucking dark.
Yeah, Josh isn't good on those either, usually.
Yep. I was so torn between 100 and 90 that... That is nice. So tough to differentiate between there.
I almost went with 95 on that one.
The bat. That was 90 off the bat. I just had the wrong bottle in mind.
Mm.
Is
everything okay, Maddie?
Yep, everything's great. So I want to do this first. We're going to do this first. So we're going to do the two bottle reveals for A and B. Glass. What? Well.
We're revealing B before we get C and D on the taste?
Yeah.
Yeah, because we have no more questions for sample bottle A or
A
B.
And B.
Sample
yeah.
A or B. All right. So sample A was a 7-year MGP Mayor Pingree. It's the Barrel Thieves Mayor Pingree.
Nice.
I think that this tastes like a toasted whiskey and smells like a toasted whiskey. Two of you agreed.
Yeah,
I agree.
Which one is
for
that?
Sure.
Which one's that?
Is that the same one?
A 7-year one from Mayor Pingree?
Yeah.
That says Barrel Thieves on it? Like, I own that bottle, and I was so far off on it.
On the nose, I agree. That does smell
toasty. You thought it was Old Forester?
Yeah.
You thought it was a 14-year-old Forester?
That's all I'm guessing. No, honestly, when I was drinking it, I thought it was a Lucky 7 14-year. I thought it was Barton. Mm. And after tasting it, I changed it up a bit.
What would make a 7-year whiskey taste like a 14-year whiskey?
Tastes great. Wait, it's also a blend. So that the 7-year is the youngest age-dated whiskey in that blend.
Hey, you know what? I hate sticking up for Sean, guys. You guys don't know how much I hate sticking up for Sean. But I thought this was an 8-year Russell's pick. What's the proof on that?
The proof is, geez, you know what? I can't tell if it's 51.1 or 59.9.
Well, 102 versus 120 is way different.
I mean, it's just the way it's written.
Yeah.
I know. I need lights. We can't see it. Damn it, I need lights. You can't. It's just like the nines look like ones.
I yeah, it's 59.9. I would have had proof on the nose.
Shiza. Okay. All right. I had 115 proof on that.
I had 120. I needed proof on A. That's what I needed.
All right. Nobody's that, right? Other than me guessing MGP and you guys being wrong. Other than that, nobody's guessing that, right?
Boom. And Dan just nailed it. That's not a blend. It's a single barrel, Sean.
You're right. Yep, it is. It does say single barrel. My bad.
Yeah. The 7 years is the youngest whiskey in that blend.
I thought it was a blend. I'm sorry.
Matt, it's a single barrel blend, bro.
Moving on.
I can't wait to
sample, sample bottle Dan's B.
Dick in when he loses on this shit to Cam.
B. B was a 90 proof. This is why I didn't ask bottle guesses for the first two, because nobody was going to guess those, right? Especially the first one. No one's going to guess that. But this was a high rye 11-year Jim Beam signature craft.
Mm. On my sheet, I have Heaven Hill ? Beam ? Knob 9 ?
Matt.
I did ask you if it was Beam, Turkey, or Heaven Hill, so you probably should have been right there with me. Yeah.
Is that finished?
What's that?
Is that finished?
No, it's 11-year Kentucky straight bourbon whiskey, high rye.
Wow. That's a crazy bottle, man.
Yeah. Did you get a dusty note on this?
No. I don't know what I got on this. Like, I don't drink dusties every Thursday. Like, I don't know what a dusty note is. Get out of here.
Black Bourbon Family says, Matt Mattis is the best. Oh, thank you. You guys are the best. Oh, Grease is here.
Oh, dear.
I'm going to have to watch the replay. Sean looks sober.
Okay, Dan's super drunk. I would like you to highlight his comment.
Sean started losing and immediately blamed me, Cam. You see that.
Solid sentence there, buddy.
Well, sometimes sentences don't really
blame me, Cam.
Good point is mute.
I just love having Dan talking at my disposal. Yeah. It's the literally best thing ever. You just have so many things. Like, whatever I want to say, I've got Dan saying it. Like that.
If $20 made you happy, you could have spent it on blowing hookers.
Gentlemen, welcome to the stage.
Okay.
The amount of times I've wanted to say that and couldn't think of the words, I got shook right there.
Holy shit.
Just right there. All right, sample C. I know you guys are probably just whatever upset that I'm being so slow, but welcome to Matt Madness. My name is Matt.
You're doing great, buddy.
Deal with
it. Sample C, guess the bottle. Sean guessed Wild Turkey 101. Perry guessed Virgin Bottle 101. So Virgin Bourbon 101.
Sorry, yeah.
Oh, okay, and then
sorry. Josh guessed Weller. And none of you were correct, except for Sean, because it's a 2015 Turkey 101. Oh, 2015 Turkey 101. Sean with a friggin' 6-pointer from way downtown. Boom, bang, pow. Check it out.
That's why I went 107 also, Josh, because there's like it's really floral.
It's so cherry forward, though.
Oh, dude, there's something about that. That is That's dusty whiskey right there.
I think it drinks above its proof as well.
Mm-hmm. That one was it kerfuffled me a little bit.
Yeah.
That's in that. 1,128 people in chat. Good grief. Dang. Good night. Good crazy. That's insane.
Thanks for being here to see me lose, everybody.
Goodness gracious.
That might be your win, Sean. That's a fantastic call.
We then moved to sample D. I said, guess the bottle, sample D. Sean guessed Widow Jane. Perry guessed Bernheim Wheat Whiskey. And Josh guessed Dickel 9-Year.
I went with a Dickel blend. So we all agree it was Dickel, right?
No, well, I said bourbon up, and got those points.
Yeah,
I hedge.
It wasn't a Tennessee whiskey. It was a bourbon.
I hedge.
Oh.
I'm a bad test taker.
Dude, I messaged Dan. I was like, that just smells like fucking Dickel. I can't get over it in any way, shape, or form. It just feels like Dickel.
Yeah.
Matt, you there?
But it was a bourbon, though. Yep. Right?
I have no idea what the score is.
Like, when we... Yeah, I have no idea either. I was keeping track and then instantly forget what it's doing. When Matt was like, hey, what is this one? Is there Tennessee whiskey? I smelled it and go, that's Dickel. We're good. And then I was wrong. So,
Okay. So I just looked at the scores. I didn't look at Ant. Josh, can you be more specific about what Dickel 9-Year you're talking about, please?
Uh-oh.
What? I don't know what that means. Like,
you said it's a Dickel 9-Year.
Oh.
Yeah, just like the Dickel bourbon, the thing.
Well, no. You just said the thing. That doesn't. I'm asking you to define the thing.
Like, are you talking about like a source blue note from Dickel or something? I'm talking about the label.
You're talking George Dickel 9-Year.
Yeah. The thing.
Sour mash whiskey.
Whatever it is, I can go get the bottle if you want.
Yes.
Well, it wouldn't be blue note because that's Tennessee whiskey.
If Josh, yeah, Josh, please get the bottle, because this determines this is a determining factor in what's happening here, and wow. The only fair way to do it is to know exactly what he's talking about.
I will put my complaint to the FIA. You'll hear from my lawyers.
I'm going to send you a
listen.
Text.
The FIA doesn't care. All they're cared about is getting people safely from airport to airport.
No, nope. That's the FAA.
You change the letter. Josh changes the number. It's whatever.
FIA is for Formula One. They're the like governing body for the race.
Oh, sorry.
That's what you were talking about.
Aged 8 years. Yeah.
The reason I ask is because
that says 8 years.
Because you said 9-Year.
I don't ever drink.
You
that.
also called it a bourbon.
Yeah.
It's
and Sean was a point ahead of you until you literally just nailed that bottle. So there it is.
Can't see it, but cool.
It's there. It's definitely there.
Dang.
So Sean, geez Louise, that was that I went through so many flips in my head because the thing is, the first question was, is it a bourbon or Tennessee whiskey? And then Josh guessed bourbon, which actually adds to his answer that it's a, because this is labeled, they labeled it the bourbon. This is one where they labeled it specifically bourbon and not Tennessee whiskey.
Yeah. I just don't drink it. That's
That's because none of us do. Every one of you except for me gave it a great review and none of you drank it. And I'm not sure if you did or not. But Sean, do you still drink it?
Sean's
where did Sean go?
He left. He said, I'm done. God. Josh is making enemies over here. So it doesn't matter that he said nine.
Is this a 1-point swing?
Because you used to be really specific, Matt. So that was why. Because like if he didn't say eight and he said nine on the text.
Right. Well, that's why I was being, that's why I wanted him to get the bottle because like George Dickel does make 9-Year single barrel Tennessee whiskeys.
Oh,
sorry, I had to pee.
That's okay. So what I did was I wanted to make sure that he wasn't talking about a 9-Year single barrel Tennessee whiskey. That's why I wanted to be as specific as possible because he did call it a bourbon and then he said Dickel 9-Year, which he just got the name of the whiskey wrong.
Is there bourbon Is it the same mash bill? Hang on. Is there?
Yeah, it's 84%
I'm
corn.
I'm shooting myself in the foot here. It is 84?
Yeah. Yeah, you probably just want to shut up at about now because you just won. Unless, of course, you talk yourself out of it, which I'm not against.
Because you want a Milner snowman.
Oh, man.
Oh, man.
But hold on.
Whoa. Don't you. What's. Now what?
Josh, your guess was Dickel 9 year, right?
Yeah. It's actually 8 year. It's
8 year.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's why you went and got the bottle?
Yeah. That's why I asked him what bottle he was talking about because. Yeah. Because he called it a bourbon. He called it a bourbon and then said it was a Dickel bourbon. So that it'd be like, yeah, that's why I had him get the bottle.
It's apples and sharpness is what I get off of this bottle.
That's what I thought is a Widow Jane. A little sweeter. I like that bottle a lot.
That's a good call, actually.
It's probably the only Dickel bottle I like. I'm actually surprised I got that much Dickel off of it because... Excuse me. We've always said like that bourbon doesn't have like the stereotypical Dickel notes.
But yeah,
I didn't
get points for Indiana.
The only note I have wrote for sample D is Dickel.
You know what?
Yeah. When I smelled it, I was like, yeah, this is.
You know what? Yeah. Gosh dang.
I'm gonna finish this.
Do we have a whole?
We have a whole four roses situation here, and I have been a stickler in the past. I have been.
I agree. Sean should protest.
I'm not going to.
The more I think about it, the more I'm like you called it. Listen, you said Dickel 9 year. If you would have said Dickel gold label, that would have been like, that's the one.
Here's what's going to happen. No matter which way you rule, people are going to be upset, Matt.
Mm-hmm. You know what?
That's just how it is.
Son of a bitch, I did it again.
Maybe.
Get away from it, Matt.
I have an idea.
Ooh, I like this. Sheila's in charge now.
Okay.
Damn it.
I was just thinking maybe Sean could be put into another round and we could do like.
I was looking for more of a. You had an idea to how to solve it right now.
Well, we should do a tiebreaker from now on forever.
I think I would imagine he's like, no.
It would be beneficial to me to actually read the. Because. I honestly didn't even friggin' read. I was like, oh my God, Sean literally won by 1 point.
Yeah.
And then I get to the
bottom. That's why I was double checking everything. Because I was like, holy crap, I don't know. I wanted to make sure my math was right. But.
Mm-hmm.
How about this? How about just throwing it out here? Look, I said Dickel 9, this Dickel 8. So I don't drink this stuff, so I don't know. But if you want to eliminate, fine. Or me, Sean, Shook, and whoever wins with Clifton, Trev, and Brian from Abandoned Bourbon. And that could be the next round. We could do the thing that happened with the whole Four Roses Bullet controversy and just see who's best next round.
It's not going to happen.
Come on, this is too important.
No, I have a solution. This is what's going to happen. This is what's happening. And... I feel like what I should have. Okay, this is my fault. This isn't either of your faults. This is my fault. And since it's my fault, this is the way I will make it right. And that this is it. Initially, I instead of thinking about it for a second, I was just playing as I was thinking. I'm like, oh, we'll go with the bottle. But let me say this: as you were going to get the bottle, there were people in chat saying it's 8 year. It's 8 year. It's an 8 year. That's what they kept in chat was saying that. I can't guarantee that you didn't see that. So I should have said you guessed the bottle wrong because you said it was a 9 year George Dickel, which does exist, by the way. It wasn't that bottle, But I didn't, and I said, I declared you the winner, which was kind of, I jumped ahead of myself. I am sending you both one sample, and we're going to do a hardcore face-off. Just one-on-one, head-to-head, and that's going to be it, to see who moves on.
All right.
That's gonna be it. I feel terrible because I should have thought about. I should have slept on it for at least a minute, but I didn't. I went ahead and declared a winner when I did not have.
Hey, all this stuff is loose and fast, and I think everyone here understands that. So, What's good is good, man.
Can I say this?
We're just having and fun.
When I have this feeling in my body, I should probably just go the other way. When I sent this, the first question I asked was, is it bourbon or Tennessee whiskey? And then I was like, that's a slippery slope, Porter, because someone's going to get pissed about it.
Yeah.
No. Jack Daniels can do the same thing.
But George Dickels literally said, this is our bourbon. Mm-hmm. This is like they said, this is bourbon. But it's also distilled in Tennessee. So, yeah. But at this, so I was like, I probably maybe should avoid it, especially for the kickoff. But I didn't.
Buddy, no one here is ever going to be mad at you about this.
I'm mad at myself.
This has been a fun time. All I can say is thank you for having me.
Matt, you dumb idiot!
I look forward to seeing Josh in our one sample face-off.
I do not look forward to that.
Hey, there are samples that we both got right, and there are both samples we got super wrong. So it'll just be what it is, man. Like, one sample, let's fucking do this. And shit happens. It wouldn't be Matt and Madness. Yeah, Jesus. Fucking hardcore.
This is real hardcore.
This is hardcore. Like,
this is people's like appetizer to the next round.
Yeah. This has been a lot of fun. So thank you, Matt, for doing this.
Shut down. Like
you guys, everyone, there's been a lot of fun. So thank you guys.
Thank you, Sean.
Aaron,
thank
you for doing being this. Here. Shayla, Bacon, I Matt, paid you more fucking quick and money to cheat.
Loved ones that will face off. Don't be yourself out, buddy.
No.
Thank you, Toshi and OMJ. Super chat. So Adriana, if you're in chat, let's do the giveaway. And then was the final text Dickel 9 or Dickel 9 bourbon? That's actually, yeah. See, that's what I'm saying is I got ahead of myself. If it was, but he did guess bourbon at the very beginning. That was my point. But is he guessed it was a bourbon right from the beginning? So it's like, does he really have to say it again?
We're stupid not going to make everyone happy. So, you know,
no, that's I'm right. Just trying to make, I told you.
Whatever I just you do, make 1,062 people happy.
Yeah.
Yeah, you can't make everyone.
Oh, Mr. Jiggs, hardcore steel cage match, single sample for the win. Let's freaking go. Hell's
like,
yeah.
Pork guy.
No matter what, it's been a lot of fun.
No, Cam's. Oh, I had Cameron in the background ready to bring him on, and he's gone now.
Aww.
I'm sorry, Cam. I was literally about to bring you on, and then I'm sorry. I just.
Come back, Cam.
He's mad at me.
He loves you.
I can't have a champion upset with me.
He's probably like, what?
I don't even deserve this shiny shirt.
I'm assuming that's what he's doing in the background right now.
Cameron, defending champion.
Hang on.
Hello?
Hang on. I don't have my headphones working. I can't hear anything.
Does he have 4 minutes right now?
Oh, since he can't hear anything, what an idiot, right? Everybody? This stupid idiot.
He beat our fucking ass on Tuesday.
He's flexing with the Stag Junior bottle. What a bee.
Is that Stag or Stag Junior? Is that Batch 19?
It's the new one. He just posted a video about it.
Behind my camera. God.
Okay, there we go. It's Batch 19.
Yeah.
God damn it. It's Batch 19. Sorry.
With
this is just still on the table from last night. Yeah, this was last night's stuff. I
caught a little bit of your stream last night. Okay.
What a crazy I just caught the end of this.
For a little Stag.
Oh man.
Oh man. So yeah, I did the thing again, Cam, where I goofed up.
Yeah,
I mean, at the end there.
I didn't catch the whole. I mean, I caught some of the exchanges. I was driving home, but I wasn't watching intently. And then I came in the door, and it sounded like all hell broke loose. So I don't know.
Cam, we had a Bullet versus Four Roses situation.
I mean, I kind of got the idea of what was going on. I have my thoughts, but I was kind of in the chat, but, you know.
I mean,
you can't say I have my thoughts without.
No, I'm not going to say. It doesn't matter. You're doing the cage match. That's cool.
Whoa. No.
You can go back and read your thoughts, Cam. You might as well just say it.
I don't care.
That is some mental spouse warfare shit where you're like,
yeah, it is.
yeah, no, honey, it's great. It's fine. You don't have to shovel the driveway. Don't worry about it.
Look, hey, Cam, I want to hear your thoughts because this bottle was literally in the garage closet. I knew exactly
the
where
garage.
I just
in the garage.
I don't drink it, so I didn't know that.
That it was, you know, you were saying 9, but you knew it was that bottle. That's so hard.
Matt, where did you get that Wild Turkey from?
So there is where my wife is travel nursing at, this little town in like Western Colorado. This is funny because I went into the store. They have an old Rip 10 for like $1,500, and I almost pulled the trigger. Then I realized that.
Don't do that.
But they literally told me this. I said, how much is that? She's like, it's $1,500. And no, I think it's 1400. Yeah. It's 1400. She said, manager says that if you take it out of the case, you have to buy it. I'm like,
what? Okay, you got to fuck with them at that point in time. Be like, yeah, definitely. Put it on the conveyor belt and walk away.
Swipe this card. Oh, none of them work? That's weird. That's so super weird.
Is that my library card? Weird.
Yeah. Anyway, but so I go in there and then they had this turkey just sitting there. And I was like, cool. So I bought it. And then I went in there a couple more times and they didn't have any other ones. Just about the only one. And then I went in there like a month later and they had another one sitting there.
So I'm like, how in the just, back? Like
they're just finding these things and putting them out randomly or what? I don't know. So I've got a backup of it too.
Oh, nice.
But yeah, it's good.
Salad. Dude, that's fantastic. That's like dusty turkey. It's got that like weird, like I wrote down a turkey ? Off the nose and then came back to it. It was like, dude, that's fucking floral. That's weird. Like, I don't get that off like modern day turkey. That's like dusty turkey shit right there.
And that's only from 2015. There is, okay, I have another bottle that I have. I think I told Cameron about it actually. That I will be sending at some point during my banish to somebody, but it's from a different distillery around the same year. And just tasting it, I'm like, what on earth? Like, what a difference like 7 or 8 years makes. It tastes like a completely different spirit altogether. It's like so dusty and not an expensive whiskey.
Mm.
Choose a random number between 1 and 203.
What, 115?
Set a timer for 2 minutes? I did not say that.
It's 117, Matt. That's the random number.
Choose a random number between 1 and 203.
I've never prayed for something harder.
Focus. Boom. Oh, look at that. That's incredible.
Dang it.
142. Adriana.
I wanted 117.
Is the winner. Yeah. Thank you, everybody, for being here tonight and super chatting. And I'm sorry that the result was a bit. The last
we'll
question,
get there.
Too. Super. We'll get there. We will get there. And I will have so much prepared for it. This will not happen again. Cam, what were your thoughts?
There you go. That's what I hear.
So you said something about
shut up for a second.
Yeah, good.
I'm going to bed. Good night.
Good night, Aaron.
Bye.
She's had enough.
It's late.
Sleep well.
Bye, Aaron.
This is like an hour and a half past her bedtime, so
likes to go to sleep when the sun goes down.
That's true. She's like a farmer.
Yeah. I know that from watching all of your videos.
Dadgummit, you're so sexy, Matt. What the dude? Come on now.
Listen, Cameron, I'm talking to you. That's why I made myself big, because I wanted to make myself seem what's the word? The word is if you're in charge, if you're like a super, not a super, but like a
managerial. I don't know.
Not quite that. No, it's more like somebody who has like a somebody in chat knows what I'm talking about. Somebody who's as dumb as me. But also is way smarter. I have
authority.
Not big. Damn it, not big. Two people said big.
Intimidating.
That's closer to what I was thinking of. I have some sort of, yeah. Anyway, you get what I'm saying.
I got
what
you.
I'm saying is this: authoritarian son of a bitch, Mark Eimenacker, you glorious bastard. Pardon my language, but I love you for not empirical. No, I'm not. I don't go that
nice. Authoritarian.
I wanted to make myself appear authoritarian. Cameron, you are the defending 2022 Madness Whiskey Tasting Invitational World Champion. Uh-huh. And I don't say this, another word I can't think of, lightly? But you're lightly. Yeah, that's the word, which is embarrassing. Your opinion matters and I take it to heart and I think it counts. So whatever you have to say, I actually, take it to heart. It's not like Sean's just blasting off at the hip or whatever. It's like, I trust you. So what do you have to say?
Wait, home.
Where trust am I?
Cam?
Oh, what happened? Oh, there we go. Sorry, I look like this, by the way. I think you said something about he could have seen.
I don't give a shit. Whatever. Like, who cares what Cameron says? Oh, gosh. That was a joke, Cameron. That was a joke. That was. Hey, if you're. Put yourself in my position. I had to do it.
Hey, what's up?
Cam, how was your band concert tonight?
He's leaving himself. I feel like I'm so lost without him.
Can I be honest? The fact that Sean had a cat butthole in his face all night.
I think this sets a dangerous precedent, Matt. I actually do. To call a bottle, to mean a bottle, but not call it correctly, I think part of the competition is knowing the bottle, because this could happen in later rounds in other ways. And if you have to do this another time or whatever, I think it's a dangerous thing. So I I didn't see the whole round, so I don't know. But I don't think you can base the first guess of bourbon on what the bottle guess is. We all know that we hedge along the way, and we start changing our minds along the way. And so I think Shook is right. If that last text didn't say Dickel 9 bourbon, I wouldn't even consider partial credit. But the thing is, there is a big case to be made here for a partial credit guess, which would put him over the line. That's where it gets a little bit hairy, I think.
I think Shayla can comment on me saying hedge. I did comment hedge on the bets that I hedged.
The ones that he hedged.
I still don't think that's relevant, though. I don't think that's relevant.
What I probably should have done.
I love being in the middle of a debate.
I knew it was close, and so what I should have done is say, "Tell me exactly what bottle, what the color is, like, you know, kind of."
I don't think that matters. I think you have to know. Part of the competition is actually, in my opinion, knowing the details of the bottle. But the fact that Josh went and grabbed the bottle is a testament to knowing the bottle, but misspeaking on the age is tough.
But you're doing answers on, like, you get points for exactness, not on feelings. And
right. And that's what that's the camp that I'm in. Okay. Oh my God. Dude, I mollywopped that bitch the other night, and he's still talking. Look.
Oh, wow.
Look, I gave him Armagnac, and he's still lost. I'm just saying.
Jesus.
Sorry, I've been playing Harry Potter all night. I
mollywopped that bitch. Best comment of the fucking day. Holy shit.
You came
shit.
In on your broom?
It kind of looks like you just got out of your winter recital from high school. Yeah.
Dumbledore just died. Okay, I'm pissed.
Oh,
holy shit!
Spoilers.
Mollywopped. My
spoiler alert.
Yeah, spoiler alert. Cam, Jesus.
It's been 12 years, but spoiler alert.
You guys had you have time. You had time to see movie 6 over the last decade. You're good.
Yeah. Holy fuck, that's too good. Too fucking good.
Where's Shook?
Super chat.
Where's Shook?
Let me say this. And I think I said it already, but I would just like to make my point even more clear.
Get down.
Cameron, I agree with you. And I think that if I would have thought about it for a minute longer, I would have made the same decision. But unfortunately, it's kind of like one of those things where Steve Harvey's like, blah, 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 blah. And then he's like, blah, blah,
but
blah.
He still had a definitive answer as to who won on that card.
Yeah, but he said
no. Oh, dude. We're having so many malfunctions.
This is my bad.
Steve already said the wrong one.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Well, so did I. I think...
Yeah, Steve Harvey literally read the runner-up as the winner.
Sean watches literally all of the game shows.
So I have all this stupid stupid knowledge ever.
But, so what you think that is when I declared Josh the winner, that was me declaring...
No, I have no standing one way or the other that I think that you're going to rule one way or the other, Matt. I don't care.
I feel very firmly both ways.
Yeah.
Can I also say this?
I'm just saying what happened with Steve Harvey.
Let me also say this. I mean this sincerely. If this were any other contestants, if this were, let's say, I don't know, anybody else, then I probably
me and Clifton.
I'd choose Clifton every time. Every time. But just joking. No, but what I'm saying is this.
It's been fun seeing you guys.
Josh has his hand up right now. I think you.
But let me finish my sentence. I've got a sentence in which I'm speaking on. Josh, I'm in the middle
wait.
Of.
You got to wait, man. You got to wait.
No, I'm waiting my turn.
I feel like this. I don't want to look like I'm playing because I'm close friends with Sean. Like Dan and Sean are like I don't want it to look like I'm like, oh, you know what? I changed my mind and Sean's gonna win because Sean's my friend and
he
would get a more. Do you know what I mean? Like I don't want it to look that way. Which is, I feel like some people could be like, oh, he just wanted him to move forward, but, and I don't give a shit what people think. Why do I care? This is all
me
just
shit on me all fucking night. By the way.
Because I love you.
Yes. Out of love.
I didn't shit on Cameron at all. For a good reason.
Well, I mean, it's hard.
Anyway, Josh, go ahead.
Wait, I forgot what I was going to say.
You had your hand up.
What was I going to say?
You're like this. You're like...
I got so entrenched in yours and Sean's bromance that I totally forgot what I was going to say.
I mean, we do love each other. It's soft-spoken, and the embrace is godly. But, yeah.
Hey, Sean. That. I loved him first.
Fuck.
That is true. Episode 106 or something, right?
Oh, it was, yeah.
Check it out.
You want to hear Porter cry.
Yep. And get really heartfelt.
It was
so looking through here, and I'm very sorry. There was a winner of this giveaway, and I cannot find the name in chat.
Oh. It was Tony Bag of Donuts.
I haven't been watching chat, so.
What?
It was Tony.
Oh.
He is already thanking you with a super chat.
Chat is what Aaron does for our channel, and I cannot keep up, so.
He already said, thank you, Tony. Matt. Adriana, Shayla, David, and all three competitors. Hey, hashtag Team Sean. Like I said, from the start.
Oh, Tony, shut up. you liar.
Hey.
You lying bag of donuts.
Well, good. Now I know. Thank you for the super chat. So listen. So we're gonna do it the way that we did it before. Unless, of course, I think of a different way, which is, but I think what we're going to do is just like a one-on-one thing. But like,
I know what I was going to say, Matt.
Oh, go ahead.
I'm so sorry to interrupt.
It's okay.
Literally, first round of.
Oh, Matt.
Oh, fuck.
Bring him back.
Does he know he's not here?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Sorry, Josh.
I know. I'm just saying, would it be Matt Madness without this? This is
the madness. I try to do is harness the madness and make it not like I screwed up, which I just did. And So let me say this. If I had to go back and do it all over again, I would have pushed Sean through if my brain was working the way I think it should have worked, but I didn't, and I can't just change what I said. So with that being said, I'm an idiot and we have to do it a different way. Other than that, thank you, Aged in Ore, for sponsoring this, what some people consider to be completely normal whiskey tasting competition. Sorry, I spiked your super solid friggin' sample jar earlier.
Dude, I have used those on so many trips, and they are the best. The last time I got them pulled out by the TSA, they go, oh, that's smart. I go, yeah, someone thought of that. Right.
I've seen this comment a few times in chat. Ask the audience. That's not fair either. That's like asking... That's like asking.
Because I'll lose. No. So, not fair.
Eliminates the bias.
Yeah, because there is definitely viewership bias. I'd rather
flip a fucking coin than pull the audience.
Yeah, 100%. Bro, dude, 100%. I do not want to lean on them. I haven't been watching chat, but I don't want to lean on them. Love you guys, but it's a bias.
Yep.
Hold on.
Oh. My God, I got Zach Jones in here. He's got 98 different sub accounts that votes against me. It's not fair.
Hold on a second.
What's up?
Somehow I won.
Now that we found out, Perry's like, you know what? I actually did say 120 points.
I actually guessed everything completely correctly. It's the first queen
Shayla
sweep.
Put it in the wrong tab. It's so fucking weird.
Did I do something wrong, Maddie? Is there?
No, you did not.
Okay. I always get nervous because I fucked up a lot.
He's just leaning in. He's really just testing the focus of the camera. He's like,
no, I.
Shayla, hang on, Shayla.
I actually did. Somebody in chat made a comment, and I. Using it, and I'm making a decision right now.
I just want to say thank you to everybody congratulating me on my win this week.
Wait, real quick. What are you drinking right there? That is dark as the fucking night.
This would be Elijah Craig Barrel Proof A123 in celebration of Tony Bag of Donuts' win.
Oh, my. That's Dr. Pepper. Like,
this is the best batch of Elijah Craig Barrel Proof since 2019. Really? Since 2019.
123?
Wait, you didn't, like, see 920? Yep.
No, I liked A120 better than 920.
Oh,
we are on the opposite end of the spectrum here.
Yeah, no, I love A120.
Really?
Yeah. Oh, dude, the first part of it is like, part of it's based on my initial reaction to it, but the first time that we had it when we reviewed it on the podcast, I could not understand how it was not a dusty whiskey. I mean, it had all of these characteristics of being a dusty bourbon.
Dude, I just figured how you just like compartmentalize. Yep. I literally had to make Dan say that for me the other day because I was like, I tried to say it and I go, you know what I mean? He goes, yeah. It's the ECBP batches. When people are like, dude, I like that A batch. I'm like, damn, that was really good.
Yeah.
We always gravitate towards the C's. Like most people, what I'm doing, Dan,
is I said I came to a decision, and then everyone just started talking about other stuff, which is
I'm sorry. I thought you needed a minute.
Yeah.
So what?
Sean, we'll talk about this in the green room after we're done.
For sure. Bad. Somebody in chat made it.
I'll write a note.
This is the longest single one episode like, ever. That's my fault.
Who would think that this would be more salacious than the Four Roses Bullet controversy?
So what?
I don't think it is. Matt admitted this is pretty cut and dry, but he just made a mistake.
I'm waiting.
Just saying.
Just joking. So anyway, somebody said something in chat that made me just think that this would be the solution. And I said to myself, if sample D did not exist, if neither of you tasted or guessed sample D, who would win? So I zeroed out the points for sample D for everybody. And I think this is fair. Sean has 25 points. Josh has 21 points. Josh also earned the hardcore guess for one of them as well. So he got one of his scores doubled And so did, I think Sean did too as well. I'm sorry. Sean's scored double to, from 2 to 4. Josh went 4 to 8. So the hardcore favored Josh, and Sean had a score 25, Josh 21. In order to make a final decision without doing a taste off, I'm making a decision that we're going to eliminate the sample detasting altogether. And that would mean that Sean would move forward. And I think that that is fair. Am I wrong? And actually, you know what? That's the answer. That's what we're doing.
Okay. That's both fair and it sucks. Because, like, Josh.
It does.
I honestly know, like, me and Dan have done it. And it's like the same thing. It was like, you say it. And I'm very sorry. I like.
Dude, it's, hey.
And no, I know Josh is competitive, so that sucks. But that's my final decision. I'm just canceling out because I made the decision, and it's like that didn't exist.
Thanks, Dan.
No matter what, it's Dan all good. We're just all here for the fun. And
I am, but like when it's the ambiguity of it, like being in someone else's hands, it wasn't like a clear cut. Like, hey, I had 21 points. You had 20. Someone won.
And look, this is like it can all fall back on me for me messing up on this. Like, I knew where the bottle was in the garage. Like, it's fine. It's all good. Like, don't even worry about it, Matt. Most of all, Matt, don't worry about it.
I've already messaged Dan like 3 times, and I feel so fucking bad about that.
Me too. I feel like bad too, but
what's Dan like? This was
a fun night. I had a fun tonight. I had a blast tonight. You guys are great. Josh, you are you're a freaking great taster. And I can't take that away from you. You're amazing.
You guys both
killed it. The music tonight was fantastic. Everything was great.
I failed miserably. You guys killed it.
No, you did fine, buddy.
I literally have no clue what the score was across the board. All I knew is that we were all kind of all over the map. This was a really tricky flight. Matt did a really good job crafting this flight for all of us. And
the questions were so hard.
It came down to 1 point, and you know what? I'm not mad. Like, anybody who's on Team Josh and you want to lobby for me, don't. Like, I called the wrong bottle. This was the shit, but I called it wrong. So that's my fault for not being on that all the time. So it is what it is. We're all good. We're all good. This was a ton of fun. I love the competitiveness. Matt.
Porter does what Porter wants.
Matt, you put on the best contest, period. Period. And it would not be madness without this involved. And I'm happy to be a part of the first round of the launch. Let's go.
Sean, tell him what I think.
You're banned. Oh.
Expecting more F words, but that's cool.
I'm going to try to
start eating pretzels again for the one guy who didn't like the fact that I was eating pretzels. Thank you everyone for being
here. This was a ton of fun. Next week, we have a doubleheader. Toshi Bake, Tanner Super Chat. Thought I understand. It's a tough call. You made a good pivot there. No joking, Matt. This is drama makes Matt Mattis fun. Amazing stream. Fun Friday night. Cheers, everyone. I think that Josh has a little bit, like maybe a little redemption story in the end. Maybe next year, he comes in with a battle axe. And I'm not talking about Aaron. That's a joke.
She gone.
This was a ton of fun. Thank you guys for being here. If there's still 850 people in chat, make sure you're subscribed to Stuff and Whiskey. Josh and Aaron are friggin' amazing. This is my bourbon podcast on all the podcast networks and on YouTube. Whiskey Central Shayla, she's fantastic. Drums and Drams Cameron is on a roll. Brrrr, boom, boom, bang, ching, triangle, ting, whatever. He's the best. Cameron, tell everyone how good you are. That's what I thought. And Sean's great.
He's the computer.
The computer. Bourbon Junkies, obviously. I made my decision. Sean's moving forward. We eliminated the controversial bottle. Next week, double header. We have Jason from the Mash and Drum, Jeffrey Wack from Hello Again Whiskey Friends, and Dusty Dan on the first, the 9 o'clock edition. And then the double header, the second half, is Trev Wilson from Bourbon Wrench, Abandoned Bourbon, Brian Bikey, and Cliffy from Bourbon Bites in the second half of the doubleheader. It's going to be an amazing Friday night next week. I'm sorry if I goofed up a little bit tonight, but I won't let it happen again. And
everyone,
if I do,
say happy birthday to Knox. It's his birthday today.
Oh,
my hands on my hands. Yeah.
So cute.
Sorry, Matt.
That's okay. I was looking for something fun to clip. I can't. There's nothing good there.
I got nothing for Knox. Yeah, sorry.
I got nothing for Knox. But still, thank you everybody for being here. Over 1,100 people in chat tonight. That's incredible. Wow. just insane numbers for the first week. Thank you, David and Kira. The friggin' music tonight was off the charts amazing. Beautiful, beautiful music. Everybody who was in chat, super chatted. Love you so much. Anybody who ordered one of those new Lou bottles, thank you. Not sure if those are sold out or if they're not, but pretty close.
I hope they are.
That's it. That's it. My name is Matt. This is ADHD Whiskey and Matt Madness. Like I always say, keep your head in the clouds, but your mind on knowing the difference between Dickle 9 and Dickle 8. Otherwise, you're gonna screw me up. And when I get screwed up, shit gets weird. And when shit gets weird, you never know. You never know what's going to happen, except for I'm just going to have to go with my best friend, Sean, because he has 100,000 subscribers.
New Lou bottles are sold out.
You motherfucker. You better end the screen. End it.
I know. I was just expecting those comments. Good night, everybody. See you next Friday for another Matt Madness.